west of the metro area, and this encompasses far northeastern Perry County, southern Crawford County, on into the northern, basically one half of Harrison County. This does include you folks in Corydon, Leavenworth, and just off to the east northeast of Leopold. You see that little notch right there? That is the tornado that is trying to form. So far, this is radar indicated. But in an environment that we have today, these things can develop quickly, come down to the ground, so you need to be in your place of safety. If you are anywhere in this red polygon, and you can see all the communities, it's Interstate 64 as it moves across Harrison County, on into the Carefree area, over towards Riddle, Leavenworth, back towards Sulphur Springs. That's where we have the tornado warning in effect. So if you're in this zone, get to your place of safety right now. You can see the rotation that we're talking about here. We have in green winds that are blowing towards the right-hand portion of your TV set, right next to some darker greens, even some reds, which imply winds blowing in the opposite direction. So there's your cyclonic circulation, your tornadic circulation, right on top of the aerial area. And again, this is racing off to the east northeast at speeds of 50 to 55 miles an hour. Let's put a storm track on that. And some of the communities in the path of this thing would include the Plattsburgh area around 444, Millport 445, down towards Tampico, Dudleytown, Crothersville, Austin, and also Uniontown as we move over the next several minutes, again, here in sections of Crawford County as well as Harrison County. So please get to your place of safety and stay there until the danger has passed. And I think this is going to be one of what could be several tornado warnings that occur throughout the course of the late afternoon and early evening. A very volatile situation that has formed across the area. Again, you can see the general movement off to the east northeast, the Beechwood vicinity 451, Magnolia 454, Leavenworth 456, and then we get down towards DePauw as well as Moberly just after 5 o'clock today. That's when that circulation, that potential tornado, could be very close to your area. So again, get in that place of safety. And if you would, please help me out. If you have friends and family in this zone, in this tornado-worn zone, give them a text, give them a call, tell them what's going on. They might not be watching TV, might be away from that TV. So help me out, tell them what's going on, that they are underneath a tornado warning at this time. Pretty well-developed circulation again, just off to the east of Oriole and also Highway 66 as it moves across eastern portions of Crawford County, or I should say eastern portions of Perry County. And this is quickly racing off to the east and northeast. Guys, from what you can see, radar indicated, correct?
Yes. Hey, that is the correct. It is the radar indicated storm here. We're looking at, I'm going to give you the latest here. Severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado, moving east at 55. This goes until 5:15.
All right. So again, off to the west of the metro, we have this line of storms that has blossomed, as you can see. We have the severe thunderstorm warning that's flashing in orange or that pale yellow outside the tornado warning, and a little bit better defined, if will, more defined, a smaller area for the tornado circulation, which is close to Oriole. That is in northeastern portions of Perry County, and this is slipping very close to the Ohio River, southern Crawford County, and soon we'll be moving on into portions of Harrison County as well. So stay in your place of safety until that thing has passed on through. We're now tracking the bigger line of storms that is really starting to take shape. You can see the darker shades of red, even a little bit of dark red and purple in there, maybe some hailstones being generated in a few of these cells. But this entire line segment, which is going to catch quite a few people there in southern portions of Indiana, moving quickly off to the east, speeds of 50 to 55 miles per hour. We're projecting this line of storms to impact the metro probably between 6 and 7 o'clock tonight. Once we move beyond the 7 o'clock hour, most of the storms will be off to the east of the metro area. But until that time, watching from around Louisville, surrounding regions, know you have a powerful line of storms to your west moving in your direction. Once again, you can see the cyclonic circulation right here, the Jericho area, Beechwood. This is right near the Ohio River here, southern portions of Crawford County, and this is all racing its way off towards the east at speeds of around 50 to 55 miles per hour. So far in the metro, we've had a couple of showers, but things have been pretty quiet. A little bit farther east here in Jefferson County. Nothing severe at this point in the game, but you can see some occasional showers across the metro extending down into Bullitt County, northern Hardin County. And of course, we did have that strong and severe activity as Matt and Suzanne were tracking earlier this morning with a tornado that touched down in northeastern portions of Nelson County, and it did cause some damage, winds up to 90, 95 miles an hour. So again, as you see, we're pulling out here just a little bit. Basically, west of Interstate 65 is where we have the scattered showers and storms ongoing, stretched out from Seymour to Crothersville, down just west of Salem, now through Paoli. If you're watching from Paoli, if you're watching from Jasper, Huntingburg, you're pretty much done. That is it for the severe weather, as this also marks the cold front. And this front will continue to sweep its way easterly as the late afternoon and early evening hours wear on. Farther off to the southeast, a few scattered showers. They're redeveloping south of Bowling Green. So the atmosphere, very unstable right now. We have a ton of wind energy also in the atmosphere. So what happens is when these storms develop, they grow vertically, and they tap into some of those stronger winds aloft, the jet stream level winds. And under the right conditions, they can bring those winds down to the ground in the form of a damaging straight line wind gust. And if we have some circulation and that tightens, you can get tornado spin ups as well. So far, we have this one tornado warning, just one tornado warning in the viewing area. And this goes for the next several minutes for places like Carefree, as the circulation is very close to you right now. Here's our rotation detector. This is showing us where there is some rather dangerous twisting of the winds going on. And you can see we have a rather broad sector there of some at least weak rotation in that one spot of tighter rotation that's close to Carefree. In addition, other hazards that these storms are producing, this is the hail tracker picking up at least the chances for some hail. Some of that hail could be up to 1 inch in diameter and a few of the bigger stones, but at this point in the game, it looks like primarily wind and maybe that tornado spin up as well. And it's still looking pretty good. Now here is State Road 62, just west of Leavenworth. And there is the little indentation, the little notch that we're getting good inflow, that warm, moist air feeding into the storm. And then it spirals upwards into the actual storm tops, and that's where you get some severe weather that tends to form and come down towards the ground. Tracking this tornado for you, we're tracking the most dangerous part of the cell, the rotation. Again, we're right around Leavenworth at 454, the Moberly area for 505, Corydon 509, as we get towards New Salisbury, Crandall, as well as Lanesville. That's going to push it into eastern portions of Harrison County, just west of the metro. That will be occurring a little bit closer to 515 and 520. So some of these storms will likely impact the metro by 530, between 530 and 6 o'clock. So we'll be on the lookout for some pretty strong storms impacting Louisville and surrounding regions within the next hour, that is for sure. A well-developed line segment now running from Marengo in northeastern Crawford County, getting toward towards DePauw, down towards Carefree, and then arcing back into Perry County close to Leopold, that entire line segment pushing off to the east. All along this line, folks, out ahead of this line, if you are close to it or east of it, be on the lookout for winds that could gust 50 to 60 miles an hour. And it's moving incredibly fast as well. So the sheer momentum could actually up the wind speeds just because of its fast movement. And then embedded in the line, little circulations that tend to form. Those circulations could produce isolated tornadoes from time to time. So we got a long shear axis right here that we're watching that's right on the Crawford-Harrison County line, stretching from DePaul back to Carefree. Some rotation in there. There's the tornado warning as it continues for the next several minutes. And outside that tornado warning, we have the severe thunderstorm warning that encompasses a pretty good chunk of real estate, really just south of Salem, and points off to the south. Suzanne, talk a little bit about that.
Well, you know, and this is really interesting to point out because it is not unlike what we saw this morning, where you might be dealing with smaller little circulations right along that line. And we know, even if it doesn't look terribly impressive on radar, what you may encounter, unfortunately, is still a thunderstorm that can produce a tornado and unfortunately cause some damage. And we saw that earlier with those winds of about 90 miles per hour. That was a severe thunderstorm warning that was in place in areas of Nelson County. So I suspect what they have done is decided to just go ahead and have that tornado warning there where that circulation is a little bit clearer. But right along that line where we have the severe thunderstorm warning, that's an area where we may in fact start to see some circulation and perhaps see an isolated brief spin up right along that line. So obviously something that bears close watching as that line moves to the northeast at about 55 miles per hour. And Jay, as you mentioned, just the speed of that line of storms, unfortunately, can cause some additional damage with this very powerful storm system that we have.
Yeah, absolutely. And this line is just now starting to organize. It's becoming better and better defined. As you know, earlier today, after the first wave of storms moved on through, kind of cooled off the atmosphere, kind of stabilized things. That didn't last long. Already by early afternoon, we were pushing 80 degrees, really still are. We have the strong southwesterly winds blowing in the moisture, and then you add a strong cold front moving in from the west-northwest, the jet stream energy, all the ingredients are there for severe thunderstorms, and that's what we're starting to see. Brand new tornado warning looks to have been issued, and this is for the Tampico area.
It's for Jefferson, Scott, and Washington counties. And I think you can see they've even extended it a little bit farther. Matt, I know you had eyes on this particular storm.
Yeah, this is both in the Indianapolis and Louisville Weather Service offices. That's why the warning looks a little odd. But it's the southern portions of Jackson County, southern half of Jennings County, also including far northeastern Washington, northern Scott, and a good chunk, at least the northern half of Jefferson County, Indiana, just north of Madison. These are going to go till 5:30. Jay, it's with rotation that's just off to the southwest of Crothersville there that you see, and also some indications of hail in that core as well.
That is a well-developed storm right there, guys. That really came up fast, no question about it. And you can see the rotation detector or our shear detector. Whenever this kind of takes on an S appearance, that's telling me that the rotation is quite strong and strengthening, and it's right where the hook echo is located. It's co-located with that hook echo. So no doubt we got to watch that storm very, very closely here in southeastern portions of Jackson County as this is moving off to the east very, very quickly at speeds of 50 to 60 miles per hour. So folks, if you are in this tornado warning, and this encompasses, again, southeastern Jackson, southern Jennings, on into portions of Scott, as well as Jefferson County in Indiana. Get to your place of safety right now. Crothersville, 5 o'clock. Austin, 5:01. Hardy Lake, a little after 5:05. Down towards Comiskey and Lancaster, 5:10 to 5:15. That storm, that potential tornado, could be impacting you. And now we have a low-level rotational lock on that. That's telling us that the rotation is actually starting to intensify as well. Suzanne, what other type of hazards do we have in this? Do we have some large hail starting to form?
Yeah, we can go ahead and check. It does look like when we take a look at that hail tracker, I'm going to go ahead and take that lock off just so we can see it a little bit more clearly and show you what's happening. And you can see the hail tracker. This storm does have a history of producing hail. You can see that marked by that bright purple shade there. And Jay, you were pointing out that backward shaped C. You'll notice that is actually why I think that they extended that tornado warning a little bit farther down to the south. Initially, I think it just included perhaps part of Jackson County, and then they decided to extend it a little bit farther down to the south and a little bit farther off to the east as well. So you can see right there, very clearly defined notch right there. This is south of Crothersville, and that's going to be just outside Tampico and heading a little bit closer over into the retreat area. And Jay, this storm is moving at about 60 miles per hour.
Suzanne, can you pop on the debris detector or the CC coefficient? Let's check out that. Yeah. You know, whenever we use this product, if you see one basic color, magenta or red, that's telling us that everything's uniform, basically just raindrops. When you start to get varying colors, when you get into the yellows, even oranges, even blues and grays, that's telling us that something else could be flying around. And when those colors are co-located with the rotation, that's telling us that there could be a tornado on the ground. So we'll continue to monitor that. This is a newly developed supercell taking on incredibly scary characteristics right now. That is a nasty cell with a low-level rotational lock that's very close to Tampico as well as just south of Crothersville, heading towards the Austin area. If you're in Austin, get to your basement right now and stay there until this thing has passed on by. You can see the tight rotation. Guys, this is getting ready to produce. Anything on actual touchdowns up there that you've seen?
Jay, I'm not seeing anything with that, looking at the Weather Service chat as well, but nothing that's coming in terms of any damage reports from that. Was also looking at that correlation coefficient or the debris detector, and it's a little fuzzy, but there's perhaps some indication there that we might be dealing with the potential for some debris there. We'll continue to watch it. Also, keeping an eye on that storm just west of Corydon as well, farther off to the south with the tornado warning. It does look like some of the most recent scans of the radar showing that that's cycling a little bit, and the last couple have shown at least a little better rotation. It's still rather broad, but a little bit just immediately west of Corydon.
Yeah. Okay, Matt, thank you so very much. Suzanne, thank you. Let's kind of pull out, let's kind of reset, take a look at the entire viewing area. The tornado watch, that continues until 10 o'clock tonight for just about the entire viewing area, but that no doubt will be chiseled away early from west to east as this line moves across any one location, moves east of any one location. As you can see, we have a number of warnings that have now popped on the line. In orange that are flashing, those are severe thunderstorm warnings. Thunderstorms that can produce at least 60 mile an hour winds and hail 1 inch in diameter or larger. Then in red, these are the tornado warnings. We just took off the severe thunderstorm warnings. These are the tornado warnings that are in effect. We have one little line segment here immediately west of Corydon. Again, if you are close to Interstate 64 in Harrison County, back into far eastern Crawford County, be in your basement, please, and stay there until the danger has passed. If you don't have a basement, lowest level of your house in an interior room and stay there again until the danger is past. Get away from windows. Bottom line, you want to put as many walls between you and the outside. That'll help stop any and all flying debris that is flying around that potential tornado. Okay, a little farther off to the north, this is a very well-developed supercell here, very close to Crothersville, moving off in an easterly direction. This is southeastern Jackson County. Seymour is farther off to the north. This is Jennings County. Here's North Vernon, Comiskey. You get down into Jefferson County in Indiana, where we had that tornado several weeks ago. And this is Scott County as well. And finally, the far northeastern tip of Washington County. If you're here in Little York, the basic stronger rotation is north of you, and it's very close to Austin, as we were talking about. I mean, ground zero for a tornado right now would be from Crothersville down to Austin, and extremely close to the Austin area. No doubt there is some wind damage going on and a potential tornado that could be developing as this hook is starting to take on a better development process, if you will. And then you go just off to the north of the hook echo or the rotation. Notice the pink shading near Lagoons, Retreat. That is no doubt the hail core that is forming, and this could be rather some large hail that is trying to form in that supercellular thunderstorm. So there's one tornado warning to the north of the metro, and then we have more warnings immediately west of the metro, severe thunderstorm warnings for the entire line segment, and then the tornado warning here, and it looks like, yes, right there, east of White Cloud, closing in on the Corridon area. As a matter of fact, yes, Matt.
Jay, if we can go over to Storm Analyzer Radar real quick, I want you to take a look at this. This is from the Indiana Department of Transportation. This is I-65 near Austin, Indiana.
Yeah.
So you're starting to see, too, on the left-hand side of that picture, and, well, that's just the latest update, but you saw some of that lowering and some of that rotation, at least evidence of that storm there into southern Indiana with that tornado warning on it.
Have you seen, heard anything about an actual touchdown yet?
I have not, and there's been nothing that's come out of the weather service from either Louisville or Indianapolis about that, but continue to monitor the chat rooms and making sure they have not upgraded that warning to an on-the-ground tornado yet.
Okay, if you would, let's go back to links one. Let's go back to, here's the velocity couplet. Suzanne, mm-hmm. if you would, please take me up to the northern tornado warning.
Okay.
And what I'd like to see is that debris detector okay. or the CC coefficient. And let's close in on this area right here. Ah, yeah. I mean, we're starting to pick up varying colors now. Maybe. Certainly some wind damage, at least the potential is running quite high. Basically right here immediately north of Hardy Lake here. There could be a developing tornado that's reaching down towards the ground. We'll wait and see. We'll contact NWS. We'll check in with storm spotters, law enforcement officials, and see what's going on. But please know, I mean, this is a tornado warning, and it looks like it could produce at any time. So get to your place of safety, and please stay there. Again, this is sections of Scott County, and this is going to be passing rapidly east on into western and northwestern portions of Jefferson County in Indiana. You can see the Hilltown area, Paris Crossing. I mean, we're right down on street level mapping here for you, telling where the most dangerous potential is presently located, and that is immediately east of Crothersville. Here's Interstate 65 passing off towards the south, and also that hail core that's right on the Jackson-Jennings County line. So an incredible storm that has really blossomed quickly. Yes, Suzanne.
Yeah, let's go ahead and switch it over to Storm Analyzer again, Jay, so you can take a look at this. And this is what Matt was showing you earlier. And Matt, if we just, on the bottom left-hand side of your screen, do you see where it says play video? Just hit that and we'll put it into motion on the Storm Analyzer. There you go. I think that they're trying to find us some different perspectives here, the Indiana Department of Transportation. So we are up into areas, I believe this is pretty close to Austin right here, 256. And so they're trying to kind of give us some perspective on what's happening. It looks like we obviously on 65, you can see those cars are stopping at this time. And some flashing lights are being shown here. Not super clear what's happening, but very heavy rainfall. And perhaps something right along 65, Matt.
Yeah, sometimes, you know, the highway department, you know, and the highway patrol could stop traffic in areas where tornado warnings are. So that is very interesting to see those cars stop there on Interstate 65 right as the storm and the worst of that rotation is passing it by. So, Jay, we're continuing to keep eyes on that. Also had some reports out of the Indianapolis Weather Service up into Jackson County. People looking south from Little York also saw that a similar lowering with this storm, did not think it was reaching the ground with any tornadoes. But there are some eyeballs on this storm and these cameras as well. So we'll continue to monitor that as well as the radar indications, which continue to show that rotation.
And that rotation, which actually just on that last scan looks to have intensified even a little bit more so. Let's go back to the Lynx product, our Doppler radar. And again, there's the Hook Echo immediately off to the northeast of Austin, just passing over Interstate 65, mile marker likely 35 up to about maybe 43 or 44. That was in the path of that potential tornado, and it continues to move rapidly off to the east. This is southern Jennings County. This is Jefferson County in Indiana. There's deputy on the western side of the county. State Road 3 right there. Then you get over towards Wakefield, Smyrna, and a little bit farther south of there, Hanover, as well as Madison. If you're watching from Hanover and Madison, little skirmish right now, as you should be, as to what happened a couple of weeks ago because of what happened. That supercell is going to pass to your north the way it looks right now. It will stay across basically northern portions of Jefferson County, Indiana. It's not to say more severe weather is not headed your way. There's a lot of very inclement weather, stormy weather, farther off towards the southwest and getting closer and closer to the metro as well. Tracking the tornadic part of the storm, Paris Crossing 513, deputed the same. 1 minute later, Comiskey, and then you get down towards DuPont, Bryansburg, and also the China area as we get towards the bottom of the hour, right around 5:30. So if I mentioned your name or you live around those communities, that's when this potential tornado could be impacting your area. There's the strong rotation in green, winds blowing towards the bottom portion of your TV set. Yellow, almost orange, the opposite direction. This couplet, if you will, is intensifying and moving quickly off towards the east. Soon, we'll be racing into portions of western Jefferson County in Indiana. So ground zero for a potential tornado, the Hardy Lake area. There's your rotation detector, our shear axis, which still is taking on that S appearance, a radar signature that tells us the rotation is quite strong in this particular cell. And this is our debris tracker. When you see colors that are more yellow, green, and if you get into the blues, that's telling us that we have something other than raindrops flying around out there. Could be debris, especially if it's co-located with the actual hook and also the rotation inside that thunderstorm. Something we're watching very, very closely. Just know you are underneath a tornado warning from near Austin and points off to the east for the next several minutes. The other warning that we continue to watch, we continue to track, tornado warning remains in effect for sections of Harrison County. The leading edge, though, of the stronger wind field is just about out of the tornado warn zone, and they haven't really reissued just yet. And I don't see a clear-cut tornadic signature here. It's not to say we couldn't get some wind damage. These are very powerful storms. The winds outside the thunderstorms, especially aloft, are blowing upwards of over 100 miles an hour, especially up around 15 to 18,000 feet. So when the storms tap into that, well, it goes to show you we could be looking at some very powerful winds down at the surface in scattered locations as well. Back to that powerful supercell as it's moving across portions of Scott County, southern portions of Jennings County, where we have the hail core close to Hilltown, Comiskey, and this is all pushing eastbound on into Jefferson County, Indiana shortly. There's your hail core right now, close to Crothersville, but likely just off to the east and northeast of there, and now into portions of southern Jennings County. Powerful storms, guys. These guys have really come up just within the last 30 minutes or so. We're expecting this, and you can see as we kind of pull out and take a look at the entire zone, along 65 north of the metro, scattered showers and storms, many of these going severe, embedded supercells along the line, and then you go farther off towards the south. Getting closer to the metro, here's Floyd County, right around, let's say, the Greenville, Galena area, Georgetown area. Pretty powerful storms racing into your neighborhood, southwestern portions of, Clark County, western Clark County, right around Daisy Hill, and also the Borden area. Matt, do you have something?
Want to give you an update here. Yep. This is from the National Weather Service. It said Jennings County deputies, so law enforcement, see a tornado on the ground headed towards Lancaster and Wirt area in Jefferson County, Indiana. So they have upgraded that tornado warning from radar indicated to on the ground, as reported by law enforcement in Jennings County, looking, I'm guessing, towards the south and west from Jennings County into that rotation. So that is now, at least from the National Weather Service, a confirmed tornado.
All right, Matt, thank you so very much. And that is shown up nicely here on the radar display. When you see the tornado warn zone and it has the magenta fill-in, that means they have detected an actual tornado. So there you go. Things are really starting to become quite dangerous off to the north, slightly east of north of the metro area. Again, this is Scott County. This is Jefferson County. There's the hook right there. The tornado that is on the ground, folks. Law enforcement has spotted it, as Matt alluded to, and this is passing quickly off towards the east. Paris Crossing, close to Deputy, over towards Lancaster, Smyrna. If you are in this zone, please get into your safe spot, basement, absolute safest spot to be if you don't have a basement, lowest level of your house, and stay there until the danger is past. Put as many walls between you and the outside to help any and all flying debris. So again, a very powerful storm that has really wrapped up by late this afternoon here in southern portions of Indiana, a tornado-producing storm closing in on western portions of Jefferson County, Indiana. Debris trackers showing various clusters of yellow out there, different than the magentas. The magentas indicating just raindrops. When you get those varying colors, the yellows, you get into blues, that could be debris that is flying around. So a very well defined supercell, guys, moving off towards the east. Stay in your place of safety, I should say, in Jefferson County, Indiana, until this storm has passed on by. There's your rotation detector, quite a bit of rotation and strong rotation right on the Scott-Jefferson County line, close to Hilltown, Deputy, as well as Parker Station, and moving quickly off towards the east. And soon we'll be in the Wakefield, Lancaster, Volga, Smyrna area, probably within the next several minutes. So you are underneath that tornado warning and will be for the next several minutes. Down through the metro area, we have some showers and storms that are getting closer and closer, kind of scattered about the east end. These are not severe, but we do have a line of severe storms. That's looking fairly interesting right there, guys. You see any rotation in that, Matt, Galena, especially just...
Yeah. Jay, yes, I've been looking at it. The rotation recently has looked a little weak. It's gone back and forth just a little bit. I do think that could have the potential, though, for a pretty strong wind gust, perhaps straight line upwards of 60 miles per hour. And that's why you're seeing the new, rather severe thunderstorm warning that goes from the metro, the downtown area, and back off to the north into Floyd, Harrison, and Clark County. That's going to be until 5:45, moving east at 50. For 60 mile per hour wind gust and penny sized hail with that.
Yeah, that warning basically close to the casino and then off to the north of there through New Albany, Cementville, over towards Sellersburg, Charlestown. This does catch downtown Louisville, over towards the California neighborhood, the Portland neighborhood. Severe thunderstorm warning in effect for portions of the metro now for the next several minutes. For, again, what could be a pretty strong wind gust that's going to come through within the next likely 15 to 30 minutes or so. Suzanne is tracking it for us, and you can see Lanesville, it's on top of you as we speak. Floyd's Knobs, 518, 523 New Albany, and we get closer to 530 for Jeffersonville, and this will take it into the downtown region as well, the Yum Center, the rest of the downtown area, again, closer to 530. That's when some powerful winds could be working through the metro area. And then farther off to the southwest, notice one thing. They did discontinue the tornado warning in Harrison County. We were expecting that as that rotation, as Matt talked about, did become very ill-defined. Now looks like more of a straight-line wind gust. So we'll watch it, and we'll watch it very, very closely. Southwest of town, some pretty strong storms, but again, no tornado warnings in effect in the Louisville area or southwest of the metro. This is the tornado warning that we do have in effect, and it is now moving into western portions of Jefferson County in Indiana. You can see the tornado warning flashing. Folks, if by chance you have friends, family, relative, whatever the case is, please give them a call, give them a text, tell them what's on the way, especially here in sections of Jefferson County, Indiana, southern portions of Jennings County, and even into Ripley County, even though that's not technically our viewing area. If you have friends and family up there, give them a call too, southern Ripley County, tell them what's going on. Nice little hail core. Boy, that looks kind of nasty right now. State Road 3 north of Comiskey, some rather large hail likely occurring in this particular supercell, and this will again carry it into the DuPont area shortly. This is southern Jennings, this is Jefferson County, Indiana, and you can see State Road 250 out of Paris, Highway 7 west and northwestern Jefferson County, Indiana, getting very close now to that rotation that is occurring, that S-shaped appearance, which tells us the rotation is fairly strong right now. And again, several minutes ago, Matt told us that law enforcement up in portions of Jennings County, western sections of Jefferson County, Indiana, did indeed detect a tornado on the ground. And there's your velocity couplet in green, winds that are blowing towards the bottom portion of your TV set, red the opposite direction. Notice gate to gate, they're right on top of one another. So the rotation is very tight and very strong, further indicating that the tornado is still either occurring or could occur again at any time. This is a dangerous cell moving into western portions of Jefferson County, Indiana. Looks like we have more activity closer to Floyd County. Matt, are you watching that right now?
I do have eyes on that. And you know, just recently, Jay, and you alluded to that a few minutes ago, some of that rotation is starting to try to wrap in right along where 64 meets US 150 there in central Floyd County.
Yeah.
Also looking at a few of the cameras from the Indiana Department of Transportation, I've seen at least some lowering. And there's even been some reports that some of those lower clouds are rotating, but nothing on the ground yet. So keeping that in mind, also got an update from Jefferson County, Indiana emergency manager saying that they're seeing that same lowering, but that deputies there are reporting that they do not see a tornado currently with that northern storm, but with the storm right there into Floyd County, seeing a little uptick in the rotation. And here you can also see, as we're looking a little farther on off towards the west and northwest on our own weather cameras there, you see the very dark skies and perhaps just left of center, a little bit of a lowering of that of those clouds,
yeah,
too.
Yeah. Yeah. Can we take a look at the other camera from the Sheraton?
Sure.
And let's move that around and get a western vantage point.
Okay.
We should be able to see the lowering from that camera as well.
There we go. Camera 6.
Go.
Is that all right? Is that an angle for you, or do you want me to scoot it over a little bit farther?
Let's scoot it maybe a little bit. Boy, it's really hard to tell, isn't it?
Yeah. So what we're taking a look at here, now you can see the Ohio River to give you some measure of perspective. So the camera is right here in southern Indiana, and it's pointed back a little bit farther off to the west. You can see that that camera is shaking quite a bit. So obviously you can see of our bridges, this bridge right here is the second, well, you can't see me do that, but here is the Second Street Bridge right here. And then as we take a look off to the distance, this would be a little bit farther off the Sherman Mitten Bridge.
Yeah, you can see it
way
out there.
You can kind of see it right there, well off into the distance. Probably helps if you point that out. So there's the Sherman Mitten Bridge over there.
Way out there.
To give you some perspective, but a really ominous looking sky out there, Jay, as that line of potent storms continues to move through. And you can see that turbulent sky as well.
No question about it. This is the line of storms that's coming with the cold front. Once this passes across any one location, the severe threat will start to drop off behind it. And I think the deeper we go into the evening, by 8, 9, 10 o'clock tonight, we'll be pretty much done with any and all severe threats. But you can see as we kind of pan that camera, looking back off to the west now, north of west, very, very dark skies. And this is also where our rotation detector was picking up some of that stronger wind flow, perhaps even some dangerous twisting of the winds going on. And this is moving into sections of Floyd County as well. And this is what's pushing towards portions of the metro. This is what's coming towards New Albany. This is what's coming towards Clark County, moving into Clark County as we speak. And this will soon impact the downtown area, portions of Jefferson County, where a severe thunderstorm warning is in effect. That warning catches Jeffersonville, Clarksville, the downtown region, over towards Portland, almost down to Rubbertown, the California neighborhood, for example, all included in this severe thunderstorm warning. And Matt talked about those brighter shades of green, no doubt winds that could be in excess of 60 miles per hour anywhere along this line segment, and that is why the severe thunderstorm warning has been issued for sections of Jefferson County, Kentucky, the metro, and points off to the north and also the west. We're tracking it for you. Hamburg now, we get down to Jeffersonville about 5:30. That'll take it into the downtown region as well. River Bluff, a few minutes, after 5:30, and then we'll get into the eastern portions of the county, northeastern portions of the county, after 5:30. So anywhere across Jefferson County, and most notably in the near future, northern and northwestern Jefferson County, portions of southern Clark County, be on the lookout for some pretty strong winds that will be blowing through your area in a very short order. These are severe thunderstorm warnings. We have additional severe thunderstorm warnings farther off to the southwest on this line. Here's the Corydon area, strong storms from Corydon down off to the southwest. We continue to track this for you, and you can see it's in the metro, the downtown region, 5:30, River Bluff, 5:32, Mockingbird Valley, right around 5:34, 5:35. And there's your wind field. You can see these brighter shades of green. Those are telling us that the winds could easily be in excess of 60 miles an hour in scattered locations along this line segment that is now across Floyd County, extending into Clark County, and then back off towards the south-southwest on into Harrison County as well. And that's what's coming towards the metro. You can see the storms farther off to the southwest of there as well, producing severe thunderstorm warnings in our southwestern communities. Okay. Here is the tornado warning. This remains in effect. Guys, we have an update on that by any chance as far as on the ground or anything? Have we got any other updates?
The Weather Service is still treating it as a confirmed tornado as it now starts to move near and south of DuPont there in Jefferson, northwest Jefferson County, Indiana. Jay, trying to look and looking over things coming out of the National Weather Service, not getting any immediate reports of a tornado currently on the ground. In fact, the last report was different from what Jennings County Sheriff saw when it was moving into Jefferson County. They saw the same lowering, but didn't think they saw a tornado on the ground. So it may be kind of hopping a little bit. And I think we've seen some of those fluctuations in the rotation too in the last several scans of the radar. But right now, it looks to be the worst of that rotation near and just south of the DuPont area. Maybe even wrapping up a little bit on that last scan, Jay.
Yeah, no question about it. I think we have to treat this, though, as a tornado that could be on the ground right now because the environmental winds really support that. They're very, very favorable for tornadoes across the lower Ohio Valley today. That's why we've had this relatively amplified risk for severe weather late on this Tuesday afternoon, and we still have that low-level velocity lock on the radar scan is indicated by that red kind of donut that was going around. That tells us that this rotation is extending down to the ground. And this is strong rotation. You can see that couplet right there. Very, very well defined. Middle Fork, 5 points, DuPont. This area, the area in between ground zero for a possible tornado. There's State Road 7 right there. It's right on top of that zone in between DuPont and 5 points where there's a tornado. It could be on the ground as we speak. And if anything, it might be even a little farther east now, heading towards the Middle Fork area. And you're getting into North Breeding Road, north of Middle Fork. There's Galloway Station. So we are right down on ground level here for you, tracking where there could be a storm. Again, ground zero here in western portions of Jefferson County in Indiana. Very, very intense wind field associated with this tornado-worn storm. And on top of that, in addition to a potential tornado, this has had a pretty strong hail core. I mean, some of that hail could be easily over an inch. Have we heard anything about the hail?
So far, I have not seen anything about the hail. You can see, though, Jay, as we're kind of sampling some of the winds, and you can see those winds 70 miles per hour. I would not be surprised if we were starting to see some of that wind come to the ground. Certainly, the environment is favorable. And we were also talking about the storm motion. These storms are flying at about 50 to 55 miles per hour. So just the speed, that forward speed of the storm is a major concern. And you can still pretty clearly see, Jay, that gate-to-gate shear, and it looks like it may have ramped up just a little bit. You know, Matt was talking about this earlier. Sometimes our storms, they can strengthen, they can lift up, they can weaken, they can cycle through. And so far, we, I think, have been seeing that perhaps with this particular storm.
Yeah, and there was that potential, Suzanne. You nailed that on the head. There was that potential for cyclical supercells on this Tuesday afternoon, and we think that's what's happening with this one. In other words, it intensifies, can produce a tornado. That tornado can weaken, lift. Other intensifications happen only to see the tornado redevelop. So that may be what's happening here in western portions of Jefferson County in Indiana. Suzanne, storm relative or base here?
This is storm relative right here.
Can we go over to base
quick?
And can we zoom in? Let's get a gate to gate. Go ahead and do a query on that for me.
Wow.
Okay, that's fine. What about that? Okay, so at least we're looking at almost 80 mile an hour gate-to-gate shear, which would indicate very, very intense rotation. And with the lock that we've been seeing on occasion with this particular rotation, that tells us that it's likely down near the ground. So dangerous twisting of the wind, certainly ongoing, as clearly seen here on the rotation detector here in west and northern portions of Jefferson County in Indiana. I talked about this supercell passing to the north of Madison and Hanover earlier, and indeed, that is what's happening. It will stay north of you folks. Other strong storms, though, could arrive a little bit later on. But there is that rotation as we're kind of going into a 3D mode now, showing you this storm as far as the vertical structure is concerned. And that rotation extends not only from the ground, but up through the thunderstorm. The higher that rotation extends up into the thunderstorm, the more developed this storm is, the better chances it has to produce severe weather. In this case, a tornado. So again, if you are here, northern portions of Jefferson County in Indiana, stay in your place of safety, please. You are underneath a tornado warning. Get to that basement, no basement, lowest level of the house, interior room. Put as many walls between you and also the outside. Tracking the tornadic part of the cell, heading towards Bryantsburg around 536. The Cannon area, 542, and Pleasant, right around 550. That will keep it north of Madison, north of Hanover, north of Carrollton as well over the next 30 minutes or so. Once this storm clears Jefferson County, Indiana, it will be moving out of the WLKY viewing area. Boy, powerful storms, guys. Can we take a look at the tower cam? Let's go back to the main tower cam. Ooh. Hello.
There you go. And this is our Sheraton camera here. Did you want to have the tower camera?
Yeah, let's look at both of them. Let's look at all these cams. All right, so we have, what do we have here? The tower cam here. Say that again, Troy. That's our tower cam here at the station, looking back off to the west, and you can see that shelf cloud, clearly defined shelf cloud as it's moving very close to the downtown region. This is just off to the west and north of the downtown area, kind of straddling the Ohio River, and you can see that lowered cloud base. Typically, once that passes over any one location, you get the strong wind gusts associated with the thunderstorm outflow. Then you get into the heavy rain shield. And you can see now we're looking back off towards the northwest on into southern portions of Indiana. Just a very well-developed line segment that's moving on through. Matthew.
Jay, a couple reports coming out of the National Weather Service and from storm spotters out of Floyd County. Estimated 55 to 60 mile per hour wind gusts have knocked down trees at Paoli Pike near the Knobs Point Apartments. That's getting close to the New Albany area. Also tree down Highway 62 at Highway 11 in Floyd County. And also on Longmeadow Drive in New Albany, report of a tree falling on a roof of a home there. So some damage with that storm as it's moving out of Floyd County there, which we're looking at on the cameras currently behind you.
Yeah, powerful storms moving on through. Let's go over to some of our traffic cams. Suzanne, what do you have?
So this is a live look at 264 and 64. As we switch over to the Lynx One product, we can show you what's happening there. So you'll notice, obviously, torrential downpours. It's a very slow go, obviously, for your evening commute. But this is an indication of some of the heavy rainfall, and I suspect this is about to get much worse. On the left-hand side of your screen, you can see that's the traffic that is currently heading westbound, heading a little bit closer into southern Indiana, either approaching 264 or the Sherman Mitten Bridge as those cars continue to make their progression. And it's going to get worse here as that heavy rainfall continues to overspread the metro.
All right, gang, powerful storms moving into the downtown area. Severe thunderstorm warnings in effect. We have a tornado warning that remains in effect off to the north. Say that again, Troy. Say it again. Oh, the Sheraton camera. Okay, yeah. This is the Sheraton cameras. We're looking back off towards the west, and you can see the very heavy rainfall, the gusty winds that are moving in with this particular line segment now into the metro area. Matt, you talked about 50, 60 mile an hour winds across Floyd County.
Yes, that was Floyd County between the Knobs and New Albany. We were getting reports from the Lafayette Township Fire Department of a couple of those, as well as down into New Albany with a tree that was that fell on a home. And that was on the in the Longmeadow Drive area there in New Albany.
Okay, Matt, thank you. Let's go back to the Doppler radar here where we have the warnings in effect for our region. There they are, and you can see they've been extended now farther off to the east to include the rest of the northern one half of Jefferson County, the metro area, on into Oldham County. And as we close in, getting some notches starting to form as well. Suzanne, I noticed that there were a couple of low-level locks.
Yeah, it looked like that just for a second. Here you go. This is just south of the Lee Hamilton in Clark County, and you can see here a fairly decent lock there that we're picking up, and that just an indication that we are seeing some of that rotation. So this is in the right near that Watson area. So this is right near areas of the Lee Hamilton, just a little bit past 60 into the Watson area where we're picking up some of that storm velocity here. So this is in the Oak Park area, heading a little bit closer over to Utica, Guthrie Beach, a little bit to the north of Glenview, so right kind of hugging along the Ohio River there, yeah. Jay.
Yeah, and there's 265 right there. There's the East End Bridge. It gives you some perspective as to where we're at. Prospect over towards Green Spring, and then you get into the Glen Oaks area, Worthington, the Ford truck plant, and this rotation. Wow, let's go right there. Let's zoom in tight on that real quick. Right there near Watson at this time, it looks like we've got some very strong rotation that has quickly developed and now racing off to the east. There's State Road, Interstate 265, Port Road. This is far southeastern portions of Clark County getting ready to cross over the Ohio there. That's the East End Bridge right there.
And actually, I think, Jay, what we should probably try to do, if we pull up one of our Trimark cameras, Trimark 1, we can probably show you the Lewis and Clark Bridge to give you some perspective on what's happening.
Just went tornado warning for that storm until 6 o'clock. That's tornado warning now. Far southern portions of Clark County, Oldham County, north central Shelby, southwestern Henry County, so it goes off to the east for a while, and also northern and northeastern, that far northeastern tip of Jefferson County, Jay, until 6 o'clock. Right now, that is radar indicated, nothing confirmed, but a radar indicated storm.
But I'll tell you what, that is a very powerful couplet that has quickly developed near Utica, moving off in an easterly direction. So again, watching from River Bluff down towards Prospect, Harrods Creek, as Matt just alluded to, the Glen Oaks area, then on into Oldham County, up U.S. Highway 42, out 329. This storm is heading in your direction. It is strongly rotating. We have a new tornado warning that has been issued for southeastern portions of Clark County, Indiana, northeastern Jefferson County, Indiana, again, to include the Prospect area, the Green Spring area, over towards Glen Oaks, on into Oldham County. And you can see very strong winds right now on the East End Bridge, our Trimark camera network. Not a good time to be traveling at all late on this Tuesday afternoon, as this zone right now is underneath a tornado warning, as we have strong rotation showing up on the radar very close to Utica, right on the Ohio River. And this is pushing into the Prospect area and will continue to travel eastbound, really close to 329 there, Cover Bridge Road, over the next several minutes. So if you're in that area, wow, has that really, really taken on a tornadic signature, as you can see. Tracking it, it's moving quickly off to the east at speeds of almost 50 miles an hour. We're talking River Bluff and surrounding communities, 539, be in your basement. Goshen, 543. Brownsboro, 547, the Buckner area in Oldham County, 551, down towards Russell Corner and eastern portions of Oldham County, close to LaGrange, around 556, as we get closer to that 6 o'clock hour. A very powerful storm, which has really wrapped up very, very quickly here on the radar scan. That's the type of atmosphere we are dealing with late on this Tuesday afternoon. Lots of wind energy, lots of twisting and turning going on, even outside any thunderstorm activity. So you can well imagine when storms form in that environment, boy, they can rotate and rotate quickly. Guys, this is going over a pretty populated area. Any confirmed reports? It looks fairly intense on radar. Suzanne, while Matt's looking at that, can you go over to our debris tracker?
Sure.
We now have a TVS signature, too, on that, on the storm analyzer. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Looks like it could be right there. This blue shade, likely not. It doesn't line up with the rotation, but that right there does. So this could indeed be a developing tornado that is on the ground or could be reaching down towards the ground. Bottom line, you are underneath a tornado warning here in northeastern portions of Jefferson County. There's Park Road, as you can see, Bass Road, River Road. Here's the Prospect area, U.S. Highway 42 in northeastern Jefferson County, Hunting Creek, that subdivision. You are underneath this tornado warning, and that's looking kind of ugly to me, guys, right there, as the debris tracker is starting to pick up what could be some debris trying to fly around that rotation.
Yeah, and that is a very populated area right along 42. You have the Sutherland subdivision right there, Hunting Creek, the estates of Hunting Creek. That's going to be traveling right up 42. It is the middle of rush hour. We have so many people that take 42 to go up into Oldham County. So, Jay, this is an area that is very densely populated. So again, this is right past that Prospect Kroger area, heading a little bit closer to the Oldham County, Jefferson County line. So go ahead, Matt.
Okay, the latest weather service has come out. A confirmed large and extremely dangerous tornado located over Prospect, moving east at 45. I'm reading text from the National Weather Service that just came out 1 minute ago. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. That is what they are saying with this storm as it moves out in toward the Prospect area close to the Oldham County line. Take shelter now.
I'm looking at that reflectivity right there near Glen Oaks. Let's go over to the debris tracker, see what's going on. All right, let's pull out a little bit more so. It's hard to say. It looks like it's a little bit farther off to the north, but anywhere from Glen Oaks. Honey, get the kids to the basement right now, please. And you're in the Prospect area, please be in your basement on through sections of Oldham County, okay? Covered Bridge Road, through Oldham County, out to near Centerfield, the Buckner area. Matt just talked about an extremely large and dangerous tornado that's on the ground. Let's make sure the news, they know that, right? The newsroom knows. Let's see what's going on. Okay, they know. Okay. We'll continue to monitor this as it moves off in an easterly direction. Let's pull out just a little bit more. So, Suzanne, can we go back to the velocity scan as well on this? And we're going to track this as we have a tornado that is on the ground, very close to Prospect, very close to Glen Oaks, very close to the Covered Bridge Road area. This is all moving quickly off to the east. Speeds of 50 miles per hour. Very, very dangerous storm. If you are in this tornado warning, you are in a deadly situation, folks. It's as simple as that. So we need you in your basement. We need you in your place of safety until this thing has passed on by. Brownsboro, almost 550. Centerfield, 557. It takes us into Oldham County, of course, LaGrange, Ballardsville, Pendleton, and then Smithfield, as that's going to be carrying it towards Henry County over the next, let's say, 15 to 30 minutes or so. Back to our velocity scan now. Let's see where we can pick up the most intense rotation on this thing. That is ugly. That is one nasty cell. Matt, you talked about gate-to-gate 111.
That was what I was looking at last time, Jay. Also, I could still make an argument for close to that. It has come down perhaps a little bit, but we do get indications of some very strong winds with that in that storm. Also want to bring your attention, what prompted that tornado on the ground upgrade was from reports of an overturned semi-truck at the roundabout at State Road 62 in Jeffersonville. So just about a mile or two north of the East End Bridge there. Also I-265, mile marker 11, so I believe in the Clark Floyd County area, reports of multiple vehicles turned over from this storm, so we're starting to get in the damage reports. Unfortunately, here in rush hour, moving over major highways in the metro area, and that's what's coming in from, we are getting those reports from Highlander Fire Protection District and their PIO in association with the National Weather Service chat there. So,
boy, that is right on Sleepy Hollow Road there as you move into Oldham County. That is just ugly right now, folks. You got to be in your place of safety. This is out near like St. Bernadette, for example, and St. Mary Academy in northeastern Jefferson County. There is Highway 1694. Here in Oldham County. This is ground zero for that tornado. Extremely large and dangerous tornado reported to be on the ground in the Prospect area, now a little bit farther off to the east, moving along the Jefferson County, Oldham County line, very close to Sleepy Hollow Road, Covered Bridge Road, carrying it towards Brownsboro, carrying it towards Glenarm, Buckner, Dempley Town. So if you're in this region, please get to your basement. Even if you're in Crestwood, please get to your basement and stay there. Anywhere in this red flashing polygon, you need to be in your place of safety. If you're in it, Russell Corner, LaGrange, Pendleton, Sligo, Ballardsville, need to be in that place of safety, okay? If you have friends and family that are in this area, they may not be watching TV. They might just not be watching. Power is out.
Power is out. And Prospect and like the Hunting Creek subdivision, the power is currently out there. So we hope that you're able to watch us on your phone. Obviously, with this type of situation, it is so terribly scary. I know many of us have lots of families in Jefferson County. It's the middle of rush hour. We've got a lot of people on those cars. I know our news crews are heading out to the scene to try to determine exactly what's happening on some of those interstates here. And I'm going to work, I think, to check out some of our in-dot cameras to see if we're able to pick up any of those cameras, Matt.
Okay, real quick, could I ask one thing, Suzanne? Let's pull out, let's kind of reset. We got to check out what's going on in other locations around the viewing area, and then we'll come right back. We still have the tornado warning here off to the north of Madison. That storm is getting ready to move out of the WLKY viewing area. Good news there. farther off to the west southwest. No tornado warnings, but storms that look awful suspicious right now, potentially wrapping up maybe again close to Brandenburg, just north of you. No tornado warning just yet, but a storm that does indeed look like it is starting to develop some rotation close to the Ohio River, Meade County, and also southern Harrison. We'll watch it close, that rotation, not all that strong just yet. Now let's get back to the tornado warning here in the metro area on through Oldham County, where is that the CC detector right there?
It is the CC detector. Well, it looks like it's out ahead. It looks ahead of the storm from what we saw. I'm going to go ahead and lapse this. This is over the past 30 minutes. Matt, I think you've got something to add.
I do think I've been looking at that correlation coefficient, that CC, and while it is not, while we're not talking about those deeper shades of blue co-located with the strongest rotation, there is some. Okay. That back with the strongest area of rotation with this storm system, we're at least getting some indications that we could see perhaps some debris in with this storm. Both Clark and Floyd County EMAs are looking into any injuries. Nothing to report yet with that, with the blown over semi at the roundabout at 62 near Interstate 265 in Jeffersonville, and also with several cars that were reported turned over in the Clark to Floyd County area. So not getting any reports yet, but just know that there are emergency officials, first responders that are starting to get and checking in these locations in these reports.
Okay, here we go. Actually, switch it over to Storm Analyzer. We can show you that here. Switch over to Storm Analyzer if we could really quickly. And Jay, you can see there is that semi that we were talking about. So this is on the Lee Hamilton, right near 62, pretty close to Old Salem River Ridge. And you can see it looks like we actually have a couple of semis that are overturned at this time. Right along the Lee Hamilton here, what you're taking a look at here on the left-hand side of your screen, obviously emergency crews are on the scene, but these are several overturned semis here that Matt was telling us about. Go ahead, Matt.
Jay, also got a report from one of my son's friends in Glen Oak, said he heard glass breaking while they were in the basement. So they're in safe places, but this is a damaging storm that we're dealing with here across the metro area, now moving on into Oldham County. So just continue to be very aware. I'll keep you updated as these come in. But we're, starting to hear reports. You see it with the flipped over 18-wheelers there. And we're getting some reports here closer to some homes in some neighborhoods as well. So I'll keep you advised, Jay. But this is a storm we'll continue to watch as it moves off to the east.
All right, guys. Thank you so very much. So let's hone in on this storm and check out the very, very latest. Now, it does look like if there's still a tornado on the ground, it has moved out of northeastern Jefferson County, is moving across central portions of Oldham County. You can see strong rotation right here. This is Interstate 71, Brownsboro, Glen Arm. This is just off to the north and northeast of Crestwood near the Buckner area, heading towards LaGrange. So basically, if you draw a line from this rotation detector, and notice how curly this is. This is a radar signature for strong rotation in a thunderstorm. And of course, this has produced, as we have had confirmation of an extremely large and dangerous tornado that was in and around the Prospect area in northeastern Jefferson County, and still potentially tornadic right near Buckner. No doubt there's a very strong wind gust also moving across central and southern portions of Oldham County, winds that could easily be in excess of 70 miles per hour, moving across areas of Oldham County along and south of Interstate 71. And you can see there's the rotation. It has broadened out a little bit, which is great to see, but still strong enough to keep the tornado warning going, obviously, as we've had reports of damage now, semis blown over, and some reports of maybe some homes being damaged as well in and around the Glen Oaks area. And you can see the powerful wind field that Suzanne is painting on the radar scan here in Oldham County, I-71, as it slices across the county, right around LaGrange, Buckner, and off to the south of there. 22, for example, very high winds likely occurring in that section of Oldham County, winds that easily could be in excess of 70 miles per hour. Daniel, I know you're over there. I know you're not mic'd, but just tell Matt, if you would, reports on social media, getting any pictures, anything like that, any folks chiming in, letting us know what's going on?
Yeah, so I've been posting the confirmed tornado on the ground across our social media. So if you want to follow on Twitter, I know power outages are issues across the region. We're posting on social media to keep everyone updated as well. Haven't gotten any confirmed pictures on at least Twitter or Facebook, but through the National Weather Service chat, we're getting some images of damage of some fences blown over. It looks like International Drive and 265. Looks like could have been a barn that was knocked over and demolished there as well. So definitely looks like a tornado has pushed through those areas. And something we're continuing to watch. And if any more pictures come in, anything does come in, we'll be able to show it to you guys.
Okay, Daniel, thanks so very much. So you're looking at the rotation detector, some dangerous twisting of the winds still occurring with this powerful supercell that rapidly, I mean rapidly, formed and wrapped up near the Utica area in southeastern Clark County, passed over the Ohio River close to the East End Bridge, right through Prospect, and then points off to the east from there to near Glen Oaks, and is now continuing to push off towards the east quite rapidly at speeds of around 50 miles per hour. So no doubt either a damaging wind gust, that potential is running sky high right now here in Oldham County. Still a tornado spin up a possibility as well. We haven't heard of a confirmed tornado on the ground within the last couple of minutes. Hopefully it has lifted, but we have to assume that it is still on the ground. We have to assume that this storm is still capable of producing a tornado and a strong tornado as everything is racing off in an easterly direction. So the tornado warning continues for sections of Oldham County, and that also clips western Henry County for the next several minutes. It does appear the rotation, Suzanne, has weakened a little bit, has come a little bit more broad, might be cycling actually.
And that, I think, is the primary concern here. And that's why I don't want us to let down our guard in this particular situation, especially because we have had reports, obviously, of those overturned semis this evening. We've had reports of a large, dangerous tornado. This has knocked out power. Unfortunately, it has also knocked out cable. So I really hope that you have our WLKY app and you can stream us live here, because this is vital, life-saving information at this point as this storm continues to push off to the east at about 55 miles per hour. Very scary, I think, for a lot of people in a very well-populated area. And of course, we're not done yet. We're still watching those storms across areas of southern Harrison County. But the only warnings that we currently have for the WLKY viewing area are currently those tornado warnings that do include areas of Oldham County, moving into sections of Shelby County and Henry County as well. And it's still a very well-defined notch there,
Boy,
Jay,
really
that you're showing us here.
Yeah, it really, really is. And one thing I do want to point out, too, don't forget, away from your TV, away from your computer, on the radio, or iHeartRadio partnership on the radio, you can catch us there as well, simulcasting on the AM dial, 840 WHAS Radio, News Radio 840 WHAS. Catch us there as well, as we'll be on there. Here's the notch Suzanne was talking about, very close to LaGrange, where we have strong winds blowing and warm, unstable air that's actually blowing into this storm, and then it wraps up, goes vertically into the clouds, spins up, tightens, and then can come down in the form of a tornado. We've already seen that in a couple of instances late on this Tuesday afternoon. Now the most dangerous part of the storm is here in eastern portions of Oldham County. Folks, just a minute or two ago, it was back near Buckner. This thing is absolutely flying off to the east. So I want you, if you are here in Henry County or far northern portions of Shelby County, I know you're not underneath a tornado warning, but get to your place of safety just to make sure, because again, this storm did produce an extremely large and dangerous tornado at one point a few moments ago back in the Louisville area, northeastern portions of the metro close to Prospect, and it is moving off to the east. Now, We're tracking the most dangerous part of the storm. We realize that there's lots of rain, wind, lightning, and thunder already going on maybe in some of these locations like Newcastle. But the most dangerous part of the storm, the twisting and the turning, moving eastbound quickly. Smithfield, 6 o'clock, Newcastle, 6:05. We'll get down towards the Franklinton area about 10 minutes or so after the top of the hour, and Drennan Springs around 6:15. That's how rapidly this thing is moving off to the east and slightly north of east late on this Tuesday afternoon. And you can see it looks like a new tornado warning has indeed been issued farther off to the east.
Yeah, and Jay, that's exactly what we're watching right here. They have decided to extend. We were tracking that storm as it was continuing to push off to the east throughout areas of Oldham County. Now it is progressing into portions of Oldham County. And as you were talking about, these storms are cyclical. They strengthen, they weaken. They perhaps come up, and then lift back down. Yeah. So certainly a very dangerous situation, especially because this particular storm does have a history of producing violent weather.
Absolutely. And you know what? That potential, that threat is going to hold on for the next couple of hours in the viewing area, most notably now the southeastern one half of the viewing area. Not much has happened this afternoon as you go south of Metro Louisville, but the air is unstable. We have a lot of wind energy and the cold front is moving through. So additional storms will likely pop, and any one of those storms as they intensify could actually become tornadic or produce large hail or a damaging wind gust. Now, as you can see, look at that notch. Look at the couplet. It's already passing into western portions of Henry County. This thing is just flying off to the east. There's Hickory Lane. There's Lake Jericho Road here in western portions of Henry County. Right down on street level mapping, ground zero for some dangerous twisting of the winds. If not a tornado, a possible developing tornado, or certainly a damaging wind gust that could be occurring with this storm right there moving easterly. And now much, if not all, of Henry County, the exception, the far northern tip, but much of Henry County now underneath a tornado warning for the next several minutes. You folks in Newcastle, Eminence, Bethlehem, as well as the Lockport area, Delville, Drennan Springs, you are all underneath this tornado warning for the next several minutes as Suzanne is tracking the most dangerous part of the storm, i.e. the potential tornado impacting Smithfield, 6 o'clock, Eminence, 6:05, 6:06, Newcastle, Bethlehem down around 6:11, and we'll go to Lockport and Orrville as we move closer to 20 minutes after the top of the hour. That's when the most dangerous part of the storm, the twisting, the turning, will impact those communities. Away from that, no doubt, heavy rainfall, lots of gusty winds, potentially some hail as well. As I mentioned, a lot of lightning and thunder with these particular cells. Back in the metro area, let's go a little farther off to the west, and you can see things have really quieted down for now. We have more heavy rainfall, lightning and thunder arcing from Buchanan, Bridgeport, along Highway 111 there. Back into Harrison County, Elizabeth, Dogwood, New Middletown, down into southern portions of Harrison County. As far as the rotation is concerned, not picking up much, just some stronger storms in this particular area. And that's why there are no severe thunderstorm warnings or tornado warnings back off to the southwest of us just yet. We have other strong storms trying to form in our southern communities. South of Hodgenville to Campbellsville to Greensburg, down into southern portions of Hart County. This would be near Hardyville, Canmer, the Monroe area. So we're watching that cluster as that races off to the northeast as well. Not severe, all the severe weather now east and northeast of the metro. Here is 71 as it moves off to the northeast, along and especially now just south of Interstate 71, most notably in Henry County. Tornado warning in effect, a very dangerous storm, a supercellular storm that continues to show signs of strong rotation every so often, potential spin-ups, and also some very high wind gusts as well. Looks like we have another little tracker, I should say, a low-level lock on that, Suzanne.
Yeah, and I think if we could just switch over quickly to Storm Analyzer, just to give you some perspective, that injury accident, unfortunately, with those overturned semi. This is what we're talking about. This is the storm that we're tracking through Henry County, where we have that low-level lock that you were mentioning. But this is a look at the Lee Hamilton. This is right along Salem, the River Ridge area. And you can see we have those overturned semis. Unfortunately, injuries were reported in the semi crashes that we're seeing here. All lanes are currently blocked at this time. Very dangerous situation. So as we switch on back for Jay to take a look at the lock on that Henry County storm, you'll notice this is part of the reason that we want you to take this very, very seriously here.
Yeah, this is the same supercell. This is the storm that spawned that very large and dangerous tornado as it moved through Prospect on into western portions of Oldham County near the Glen Oaks area and then over towards places like Buckner. And now that rotation picking up that low-level lock once again, which indicates some rotation reaching the ground. Whether or not it's a tornado actually on the ground at this time, that remains to be seen. We'll check out other radar parameters that can help us decipher that. But nonetheless, there's certainly a potential for some damaging winds and maybe still that tornado spin up now here in Henry County. And this is getting very close to the Smithfield area. It's pretty much on top of you now. Newcastle down to Eminence. There's State Road 55, okay, State Highway 55. That is running from Newcastle down to Eminence. You're getting into some very, very heavy weather as we speak. Heavy rainfall, gusty winds, a lot of lightning and thunder, and maybe some hail. Looks like maybe a hail core on the confluence of 146, 153, just south of Pendleton there. And what do we have here, guys?
That's the debris tracker. We just kind of threw this on here just to give you some perspective. Perhaps it could be from some wind damage or something like that, but I do think it's important to point this out that we are picking up some debris or something that is of a different size.
Is that co-located,
yes,
Suzanne, with where the rotation?
We're seeing, yes, it's where we're seeing the rotation.
Oh, man.
You see that right there. So this is why we obviously want you to take this storm very seriously right here. So that's where we're picking up the shades of red and green matched up together. It's also where we are picking up a debris signature.
Okay, Suzanne, thank you. Matt, can you do a little bit of research there and see what's going on? Maybe law enforcement or something?
Yeah,
spotting something?
We'll check into that, Jay, because I haven't seen anything come through yet on that. I know we have quite a bit of folks on our Facebook stream and live right now, too. And no one's saying anything about anything out of Henry County currently, so I'll continue to monitor that, but obviously, you know, the same storm that we've been watching here for some time that has a history of reporting damage. So we'll watch it closely.
Okay, so we are tracking a very powerful supercell thunderstorm that seems to be cycling. What we mean by that, it intensifies, produces a tornado. Tornado moves along the ground, weakens, lifts back up, only to see more intensification and reach back down towards the ground. And we have a very well-defined velocity couplet right now here in western portions of Henry County. Here's Newcastle. You go west on 146, okay? You get very close to that rotation, the most dangerous part of the storm. Here's Sunnyside Road. Just off to the west of Newcastle. This is closing in on you folks in Newcastle, so you need to be in your basement. Please, if not a basement, lowest level of your house and stay there until the danger is passed. We are right down on the streets, man, street level mapping, so you can get a good idea as to where the most dangerous part of this storm is actually located. This is our rotation detector, and you can see this area of darker red, almost brown, Sunnyside Road, 146 between those two, just a little farther east now, pushing rapidly off to the east. The debris tracker, okay? Notice the different color than what's going on around it, where you see more of the darker reds, the magentas. That's telling me that anything flying around out there is uniform. Raindrops, in other words. When you get into the varying colors, it's a different sort of particle that's flying around. It could be a hailstone. It could be birds, for crying out loud. In this case, though, as Suzanne had that co-located with this right here, the rotation, they're on top of one another. So it looks like we have some debris that's being picked up on the radar again. That tells us that this tornado could indeed be on the ground once again. Please be in your place of safety. Newcastle, I need you there, and stay there until the danger has passed. And yes, you can see National Weather Service does agree with me here. Notice how this warning zone has been filled in with a magenta color. That's telling me that they too are now saying this, that this tornado is on the ground. All right, so please be in your place of safety. And you can see a little bit of rotation there in the reflectivity field, a lot of rotation showing up there immediately south of 146. But boy, here in west and southwestern Henry County, this is going to pass very close to Newcastle and just off to the north of Eminence, and it will continue to push off to the east. So if you're watching from Delville, Franklinton, as well as Bethlehem, just know this tornado, potential tornado, is moving in your direction. You need to get to your place of safety immediately. Matt, what do you have?
You know, Jay, just to confirm with that, they're considering it a radar confirmed tornado. So while there may not be eyes on an actual tornado, they're going off of the history, plus that little bit of debris that we are seeing in the clouds on the radar that we've been showing you with that debris tracker. So they're using that, plus the rotation, the debris that we know is on the radar, plus the history of this storm, to go ahead and upgrade that warning as it moves through Henry County. Also going to keep eyes on some of the showers and thunderstorms back off to the south and west. It may interact with the outflow boundary from these storms, Jay. So at times I see some indications on the radar that we might want to get some twisting with that a little farther to the south of the track of this last storm. So no warnings yet, just something keeping a little bit of an eye on the radar a little farther off to the west and southwest.
Okay, Matt, thank you so very much, sir. I appreciate that. Daniel, anything on your end as far as social media? Anything, any reports coming in, pictures?
So we did have that one picture in Jeffersonville, okay, in Indiana. So we did have some damage there with a fence knocked over. And as we mentioned, I think a semi knocked over as well. No pictures on Twitter or Facebook right now. Still waiting to get some more confirmation on that. But Matt and I were looking at that storm in Henry County that the National Weather Service has said radar confirmed. So again, we are treating it as a confirmed tornado on the ground in Henry County. No one has officially observed it, but radar confirms due to that debris signature that you mentioned in Henry County. So we got to treat that as a dangerous tornado on the ground. So take cover.
Yes.
If you are in Henry County right now.
Absolutely. Thanks, Daniel. Do appreciate that. You saw some pictures on the screen there just a moment ago. That was Rolling Creek Drive, was it, Josh? Is that right? Rolling Creek Drive in the Jeffersonville area. And that's where those semis were actually overturned. So powerful storms that were moving through there, causing
like
maybe a little bit of flooding rainfall.
Tornado
as well.
Debris signature,
yes,
I believe, that we have on here.
That's exactly what that is. And again, that's lining up with the strong velocity couplet, also with the debris tracker. So everything is now telling us that we have probably a tornado on the ground here in Henry County. And this is very close to Newcastle. This is heading right towards you folks in Newcastle, need you in your basement. It is on top of you as we speak, and it is pushing rapidly eastbound next to potentially impact Delville, Franklinton, and the Bethlehem area here in eastern Henry County. The strongest rotation looks like it'll stay north of Eminence, but nonetheless, you can see the powerful rotation is on top of Newcastle as we speak. So please be in your basement. There's the debris tracker. Suzanne, would you go back to that for me, please? And you can see the varying colors. Notice how we go from the yellows and oranges to the darker reds. That's the debris that the radar is picking up, and that is smack dab co-located with that strong velocity couplet and also the low-level locks and the debris tracker that we had on our radar. So that is all the technology that the radar gives us. We can really pinpoint where the most dangerous parts of these storms are located with all this radar technology and warn people out ahead of the impending danger. Newcastle, tornado warning in effect. Much of Henry County, tornado warning remains in effect. This is a radar confirmed tornado, likely on the ground or skipping, could be touching the ground only to rise and then touch back down. Dangerous situation on top of the Newcastle. US Highway 421 right through Newcastle, the Castle Highway. Boy, that rotation, guys, is right on top of the city of Newcastle as we speak.
Right on top and continuing to track very, very quickly off to the east at about 55 miles per hour. I believe if we want to do it in double boxes, we can actually show you a live picture from Prospect over by the Hunting Creek subdivision, where unfortunately we have seen some damage here. Obviously, this is an older subdivision. Most of the houses were built in the 1960s, so they have a ton of mature trees. Obviously, this is terrible to see, but fortunately, it looks like it missed the house there. So this is in the Hunting Creek subdivision. This is right along 42, and you'll notice a very large tree, unfortunately, has been knocked down. And fortunately, it looks like the house has been spared there, but I believe this is right. This may be on Foxcroft or Deep Creek in the Hunting Creek subdivision here. Let me get a little bit of perspective here, and you can see some other trees that were knocked down. So this is, I believe, right at the intersection, perhaps, of Tallwood and Tallwood Court, if I'm looking at that correctly. But the bottom line is, in the Hunting Creek subdivision, there are tons of mature trees, and obviously a number of those trees have been knocked down and uprooted from this powerful storm.
Hey, Josh. Josh is our producer up in the booth. Josh, do we have a reporter out there right now, by any chance? Can we go to her? Yeah, let's go to Madison, and just real quick, while we're kind of resetting our radars, can she give us a quick report as to exactly where she's at, like Suzanne was talking about, and the damage she's seen? Madison, you there? Josh, just let me know when she is ready, and we'll go over to her. Oh, she's there. Madison, can you hear me?
Hey.
Hey, how
Jay,
are you?
Yes, I got you.
So, yeah, what are you seeing?
Hey, tell us. Hey, we're doing okay right now. Sorry about that, Jay. So we're doing okay right now. What I can tell you is what we're seeing is a lot of trees down like this one. We've seen a lot of older trees like this along River Road as we are driving down to this neighborhood that were down everywhere. We've already seen some police out as well, and you can see a lot of neighbors are out who are walking around seeing what's going on here. People we've seen appear to be okay. It's really more trees down, but what I can tell you is we've also heard a lot of sirens. We just saw a few fire trucks pass us as well here because they were heading down, further down the street into this division, this subdivision. So it looks like there's a lot of activity happening right now in this neighborhood. From what we can tell, none of these trees, luckily, it doesn't appear have hit any houses from what we're seeing currently here, but we do see a lot of these tree branches that have broken off, that have fallen down. And again, we've seen some people just kind of out and about surveying the damage, seeing what's going on. We have yet to kind of get to talk to people about what they heard and see here, and we will hear in just a minute once we're off air. But there is just a lot of trees down at the moment and blocking roadways. So for people, don't go outside, because right now there's a lot of first responders who are out trying to clean that debris from the road because there's just a lot of it everywhere. So we're just kind of seeing those trees down everywhere right now. So guys, Jay, I'm going to send it back to you, and we're going to continue to walk around, and we'll bring you an update of the damage coming up here in the next few minutes.
Okay, Madison, can you hear me? Can you hear me, Matt? Okay,
yes.
Real quick, before I leave you, talked about tree damage. Are you seeing any structural damage, any damage to homes? You might have already touched on that while we were resetting our radars. What's the latest on, like, damage to homes and things like that?
Jay, I'm not really seeing a lot of damage to homes. Luckily, so far where we're standing, we haven't been able to go everywhere in this subdivision yet, but from what we can see, we do not see any trees that appear to have hit homes or have damaged any homes. So that is some good news there. But again, we've only been in this one little part of the subdivision. So as far as what the rest of the houses look like yet, we do not know. But from what we can tell where we are currently, we are not seeing any damage to homes, Jay.
Okay, Madison, thanks so very much. We'll check back in with you a little bit later from now, but we do appreciate the report. Again, a powerful storm moving through portions of northeastern Jefferson County, Prospect, the Hunting Creek area, over along Covered Bridge Road, 1694. It followed Sleepy Hollow Road through Oldham County and then has continued to push off to the east. And this is the supercell. Again, a radar-confirmed tornado that was on the ground. At least it by radar as it traveled through Newcastle. There's Newcastle. It's already well east of there and closing in on you folks in Franklinton as well as Delville. Debris tracker showing, again, a little bit of lightening of the actual reflectivity field, telling us that there could be maybe still a little bit of debris out there flying around or maybe even falling from the sky if that thing was on the ground long enough. But you can see there's the strong velocity couplet now east of Newcastle, pushing rapidly off to the east. This is going to carry it into Owen County, out of Henry County, likely within the next 15 to 30 minutes, and that will take it out of the WLKY viewing area. New thunderstorm has really developed and intensified right here in the metro area. This looks to be a hail core on top of close to Payne Street, I should say, and you can see out into the St. Matthews area, heading towards, Woodlawn Park, Beechwood Village. Notice that shading of pink and black. Likely seeing some hail in this particular supercell thunderstorm. Here's Westport Road, as you can see. Everything moving off in an easterly direction very, very quickly. This is the Waterson Expressway. And then you have Shelbyville Road right there, St. Matthews, out to near the malls, which are about right here, Oxmoor, and then, of course, Mall St. Matthew, up to the Linden area. This hail-producing storm will move across Woodland Park, the Linden area, Beechwood Village, and if it holds together, continue to move along Shelbyville Road, just north of Interstate 64 in eastern portions of Jefferson County, and could impact places Lake Forest, maybe even Middletown, and the Eastwood area if it holds together. Very heavy rainfall outside the hail core. Matt, you were talking about rotation in that thing. Did you have anything that showed signs of a tornado redeveloping around the metro? It didn't look like it to me just yet.
No, but I was right outside. I was looking outside our windows. Also had one of our coworkers come out. We did have a little bit of small hail.
Okay.
And I would say when I was looking at it, 45 to 50 mile per hour wind gust. So it's definitely a strong cell that's moving here through the metro, just a little bit south of the track of that last supercell and the tornado that we've been tracking, Jay. So it's a powerful storm, but no warnings on it, it looks like, yet.
Yeah, no question. Suzanne, where are we at?
That is the Waterson right at Brownsboro Road on the left-hand side of your screen. You can normally see the VA hospital that's currently being built. And again, that's the Waterson right at Brownsboro Road. Visibility is basically down to nothing at this point. Very difficult to even see the interstates here as you're trying to maybe head home from work tonight.
Okay, thanks so very much. A rough afternoon with multiple rounds of storms rolling on through. We had the wave of severe weather this morning that did spawn one tornado in the WLKY viewing area, that in the Chaplin area, northeastern Nelson County, EF1 damage. No doubt we've had tornadic weather, confirmed tornado touchdowns in portions of the metro, actually developing very close to Utica, going over the East End Bridge into Prospect, and then points off to the east from there, impacting places like Glen Oaks, and then over towards Crestwood, just north of Crestwood, over towards LaGrange. We think it might have lifted as it moved across the majority of Oldham County, only to touch down again here in sections of Henry County, very close to Newcastle. The strongest rotation is now pushing into far eastern Henry County, and soon we'll be moving out of the viewing area altogether. As you can see by that tornado warning, notice it's filled in with the magenta color right there. Again, National Weather Service still saying that this is likely a radar-confirmed tornado, or they have an actual sighting from law enforcement or from storm spotters. There's Franklinton, Slabtown. This is eastern portions of Henry County. And you can see the Gratz area getting closer to Owenton. This is Owen County right here. So the most dangerous part of the storm, the rotation, which is right on Highway 22 here in eastern portions of Henry County, as indicated by that rotation detector, picking up that shear very, very nicely. Dangerous twisting of the winds going on. moving rapidly off to the east. Soon we'll be passing out of the WLKY viewing area altogether. We have additional heavy showers and even some thunderstorms trying to redevelop back off to the west and also the southwest, closer to the metro. Suzanne, if we could, let's go back to eastern Jefferson County, check out what's going on. And really, let's hone in on this activity right here. What do we see from Berrytown to Anchorage, wrapping back to near the Ford truck plant here, very close to the big bend of the Gene Snyder. Any rotation?
I'm not certainly hail. Any rotation, it doesn't look like. The hail looks to be the bigger concern here with the torrential downpour. So if you're familiar with this area, so this is right along the road right here. So this is Langdon Place. This is Worthington. This is 71. So this is basically close to the Springhurst area where we are seeing that hail right there. So heading into the Murphy Lane area, so the Ford truck plant right there. This is the Gene Snyder here. These are the paddock shops. This is over by Costco right here. Right. Glen Oaks is over here too. So this is an area that kind of was hit hard with that other storm. So now seeing some hail. Fortunately, we're not picking up any rotation with this particular storm at this time. Let me go ahead and kind of sample it a little bit and we'll take a look. Yeah, not seeing much as far as rotation in this particular storm. A little bit of shear showing up here.
Yeah.
That may just be an indication that it is a strong storm that we are currently watching here.
Yeah, it looks more like a hail producer than anything at this point in the game. And that hail core right there on the Gene Snyder immediately east of 71, that would be pretty close to the Walmart there in northeastern Jefferson County. And this is heading along and south of 22 over towards, the Ford truck plant. And it looks like this is going to carry it close to Crestwood, but near Peewee Valley and points off to the south.
Yeah. And Jay, actually, we have a live look. If we want to switch over quickly to our Trimark cameras, I don't know if we're able to put that in for Jay and show you what's happening. So we're showing you, obviously, the hail tracker, the torrential downpours that we're dealing with. This is a live look from one of our Trimark traffic cameras, and it's nearly impossible to tell where you are. But we're actually here on 71 right near the Gene Snyder, just a touch south of the Gene Snyder. This is actually where we're seeing the most intense portion of this storm at this time, with torrential downpours. You can see some people throwing on their flashers as they're driving through 71. So you're going to be dealing with a rain threat. And of course, we're continuing to monitor for that devastating situation that showed up onto portions of, unfortunately, the Lee Hamilton. In fact, I think we can switch over really quickly and just show you Storm Analyzer, if we could, to give you an indication of what's happening. So I know a lot of people are leaving, trying to get home from work. That is what it looks like on the Lee Hamilton, right near the old Salem River Ridge area, where we had two semi trucks that were overturned because of wind. And unfortunately, Jay, injuries were actually reported with those overturned semi trucks as well.
Okay, we're going to go over to Madison Elliott here in just 1 second. We have a new severe thunderstorm warning. Is that correct, guys? I saw in Jefferson County, eastern Jefferson.
Yeah, eastern Jefferson, portions of Oldham County over into Shelby County as well. So Crestwood getting hit hard right now. Looks like there could be some hail there. Strong winds, too, gusting to 60 miles per hour.
Yep, there it is right there. Thank you, Daniel. Do appreciate it. The other storm, the tornadic storm, is now pushing out of the viewing area, is now in Owen County. But you can see this other powerful storm. Looks like it's taking on a Boeing appearance there, a backward C. Radar signature that there could be some very strong straight-line winds trying to form. And we've been tracking the hail core, which is on top of the Crestwood area right now. But again, we've had some damage from the earlier tornado that passed across northeastern Jefferson County. Our Madison Elliott is in the Hunting Creek subdivision in the Prospect vicinity. She's been monitoring and tracking and reporting on some of the damage that has taken place in Hunting Creek. And Madison, substantial damage too, especially tree damage, huh?
We are seeing a lot of trees down, Jay. Right now we're on Wife Hill Circle, and there are a lot of trees down around this subdivision. We can show you some of this damage. If you look up at this house here, you can see that some of the siding has been ripped off this house, and we see the siding's now sitting on the ground over here in what appears to be their neighbor's yard. We've even seen some shingles that are now stuck in tree branches like this over here. You go to this red brick house right across the street, and in the tree over here, there's a shingle now in that tree. So you can see that some of the four force of the wind that blew some of the siding and the roofing off of some of these houses. But really what we're seeing are downed trees. I did just see an ambulance pass us as well. So again, we're still in this part of the subdivision we were a few minutes ago, and this is the area that we've been surveying this damage. We're going to continue to head down to see what else it looks like. But you can see neighbors are out right now. We actually did speak to one neighbor who lived in that red brick house we just pointed out. He told us him and his wife, they went down into the basement. They hid down there. They didn't see anything, but they heard everything. He said it just sounded like they heard the crackles. They heard the breaking of the trees. They said it was pretty scary because this big tree over here you're seeing, that's what they heard fall while they were hiding in their basement. So you can imagine the sound of that hitting the ground, a massive tree like that. So they said it was a little scary because they didn't know what had fallen yet. They said luckily it fell away from their house, because this tree, if it had fallen the other way, could have potentially fallen on their house. So we see, again, a lot of people who are out right now. Everybody we've spoken to so far appears to be okay and minor damage from what we see so far. But Jay, we're going to continue to go around this neighborhood and bring you the latest updates of what we're seeing. Jay, back to you.
All right, Madison, thank you so very much. Great job. And I have a feeling we're going to get more reports of damage like this along the path of that tornado as it moved into sections of Oldham County and into Henry County as well. We'll continue to monitor that situation, make phone calls to various spotters, law enforcement officials, and see what's going on in those communities. Okay, so here's what's going on at this point in the game. We still have tornado warnings off to the northeast of the metro. Those are now pulling out of the WLKY viewing area. We have a strong thunderstorm that did prompt a severe thunderstorm warning for sections of Jefferson County, eastern Jefferson County. We've been tracking this one, and now it's basically here in Oldham County, tailing back into far eastern Jefferson County, very close to the Eastwood area, the Lake Forest area, there where 64 Shelbyville Road and the Gene Snyder kind of merge. Some very heavy rainfall, gusty winds there. More heavy rain has redeveloped in Jefferson County up and down I-65, running from near Germantown down to Linview to Minor Lane Heights on into extreme northern Bullitt County. That is not severe, but we will continue to monitor it and track it. And then as we go farther off to the south and southwest, Suzanne, as we make our ways along that cold front, just some locally heavy rainfall, scattered showers, a few thunderstorms. Looks like this is the front right there. That is it. Once that line kind of tails up here just a little bit, but once the back edge moves across the viewing area, we will be done. And looking at all the latest computer model guidance, that should be occurring around 8-9 o'clock tonight. Still 8-9 o'clock in our far southeastern communities. For the metro, that should be occurring between 7 and 7:30 tonight. And you can see where the cold front is, just off to the west now, very close to the Wabash, as we go from 60s and 70s into the 50s, the 40s, the 30s. And that is the air that's pushing in our direction. Far cry different story when you wake up tomorrow morning. Much, much cooler weather is in store. Matter of fact, could see more spotty showers, maybe even a few rumbles of thunder tomorrow with pea-sized hail, just because the air is so cold aloft. But get this, could be looking at some light snow showers in here. Yeah, I said it, light snow showers in here late tomorrow night into early on Thursday morning. Okay, heavy thunderstorms continue. Oldham County, far eastern Jefferson County, close to Eastwood. Looks like the hail core with this particular cell has dropped, has really, really come down. Maybe a little bit of small hail near Eastwood. And this is now pulling into places like western and northwestern Shelby County. This was actually the hail track as we were picking up. And this is the latest hail tracker. Nothing out there. So again, means that storm is indeed weakening somewhat. Still likely has some gusty winds associated with it. Not picking up any rotation that would scream a tornado, but certainly enough of shearing going on, change in wind directions that's telling us there could be a strong straight line wind gust here in eastern Jefferson County. And this is pushing into western Shelby County. You folks in Simpsonville, near Ellis Park, the Fisherville area, That's where that strong wind gust could be located and where it's headed as well. That's the severe thunderstorm warning outline, and you can see everybody involved where winds could be rather gusty. And again, there could be still a little bit of small hail, but that hail core seems to have dropped off here quite a bit. All right, so the severe weather, as far as the number of warnings going on around the WLKY viewing area, it's kind of coming down here. We're getting into a bit of a lull, but we can't put our guard down, especially from the thunderstorm zone lining up close to the Ohio River and I-71 and points off to the south. We have to watch zones south of the metro extremely closely here over the next couple of hours, as again, this atmosphere is quite volatile. We still have some heating. We still have some instability to work with. We have a lot of wind energy. And as the cold front moves in, lifts that air, that'll get those thunderstorms popping. And then those storms could tap into that wind energy aloft. So that's what's happened thus far this afternoon. And that could happen again as you move farther off to the south. So we're certainly not out of the woods by any stretch of the imagination. And it looks like we'll be dealing with more scattered strong to severe storms up until about 8-9 o'clock tonight. Again, farther off to the south and southeast of the metro area. Heavy rainfall, gusty winds though around the metro and points off to the east and also the northeast. Daniel, what do you have, sir?
Yeah, Jay, we're getting a lot of pictures, a lot of videos on Facebook. If you guys don't mind taking Storm Analyzer, we can just go through some of those Facebook messages and videos and pictures that people are sending in. We'll try to make it as big as we can. But this was one video someone took outside of their tree, kind of just waving in the wind. The one thing, Jay, I noticed that's in common with a lot of these messages, everyone is talking about the noise. It was so loud, and Madison mentioned that in her live report as well. So many people in and around Jefferson County, Kentucky, Clark County, Indiana, into Floyd County, over into Oldham County, reporting loud noises and how loud the storm was. Here is a picture from in Crawford County from Stephanie. You can see right around a Marathon gas station, you can see part of a roof was blown off there. That's just one picture coming in. We're seeing a lot of damaged pictures and videos of balcony furniture being blown off, some interesting cloud pictures as well. Trying to get some hail pictures here from Shannon and Charlestown. Seeing a lot of pea-sized, quarter-sized hail, at least in that picture there. We also are getting some dark pictures, cloud pictures right here from Beth. As she took that picture, a little bit of greenage to the sky there as well. Sorry, scrolling through quickly. This is really interesting in Charlestown earlier today. Look at that incredible picture from Daisy. Thank you, everyone, again, for sending these. This is, again, on our WLKY Facebook page that we're scrolling through. A lot of dark clouds, a lot of scary images, some damaged pictures coming in as well. Look at this one. This was in Utica, a lot of reports of tree damage in Utica, and this, Jay, looks quite interesting. At least a lowering of the clouds there behind that house in Utica, and that's where we did get some reports of a lot of tree damage there. So, right. Again, yeah, thanks for all the social media pictures.
Yeah, no question about it, and keep them coming if you can do so. And again, don't get out there and take pictures of the storms and put yourself in harm's way. If you want to take pictures of any damage, make sure the storms are well away from you and gone. Stay safe. That's of utmost importance. Suzanne, what are we looking at here?
Let's go ahead and take a look. I want to switch around and show you a couple of different locations. So what you were just looking at there, this is a live look at 71 right near the Gene Snyder, where when we checked this shot out about 15 minutes ago, visibility was down to almost zero. So just an indication, obviously.
Oh, that was that shot.
Yeah, that was you couldn't tell what it was, could you? So that's what it looks like there. I do want to point out, this is the Gene Snyder over by Taylorsville Road that you're now taking a live look at. You'll notice some standing water out on the roads. In the metro, our primary concern, I think, at this point is the heavy rain potential with a few of these storms moving through. Obviously, we'll keep you posted if any weather turns severe, but that's how it's looking right now. This is a live look at the Lewis and Clark Bridge, and you can see that they are doing something here. Notice on the right-hand side of your screen, That's the traffic that's currently traveling northbound to move you over into southern Indiana from eastern Jefferson County. And it looks like they have all of the vehicles stopped here. And that, I suspect, is because of right over by that River Ridge area. That's where we were seeing those overturned semis from the possible tornado that we did get some reports of. So that is why I suspect that we're seeing very slow traffic now on the East End Bridge. Obviously, very difficult. Earlier today, Jay, we had the Sherman Mitten Bridge also shut down. So a really tricky day on the roads, despite the fact that it was quiet weather at the time when we had that earlier accident on the Sherman Mitten Bridge. The Sherman Mitten Bridge is, however, back open. So the Lewis and Clark Bridge obviously tied up. It's really tough for drivers out there tonight.
Yeah, no question about it. And Suzanne, you were talking about and you were showing the pictures of where the semis were blown over. Where the tornado seems to have first developed, our very own Drew Gardner is there right now at the scene of this damage. Drew, what's the latest you have, sir?
Well, Jay, let me set the scene as to where I'm at. I am on Indiana 62. We are just east of the roundabout at 265. I'm going to step out here. This is one of those semis that you've been seeing images of in this area, flipped on its side. The front of that semi also looking hard to tell whether it's crushed or whether they used the jaws of life or other tools to get the driver out of there. But right now, traffic is getting around. Surprisingly, we're not seeing a huge backup, so hopefully people heeded the warnings to stay off the road, and that's what's allowing traffic to keep moving. But when we were on 265, we were coming from the north, so we were coming from the New Albany area, and you could see the signs on the freeway warning that all lanes were closed ahead as you approach the East End Bridge, where we saw even more of those semis that were flipping on their sides. Now, I'm going to have Jody pan out of that semi here and walk over this way. I'm going towards the roundabout at 265. And if you look over here on the fence line, you can see where part of the fence is just ripped apart, almost like perhaps a tornado came through there or another vehicle might have been flipped or crashed anyway. We don't know at this point, but there does appear to be a trail of some damage in this area. We've gotten several other reports from the Jeffersonville area as we head to the east here down 62 that we are going to be checking out. But right now, really anywhere around the River Ridge area, it is a good idea to avoid it, which we see right now. Most people seem to be doing. Crews are out here working fast. We've been seeing them coming from all directions to get this area cleaned up. We haven't been able to get any word on the condition of the driver in this semi, but of course, we're going to work to get that and go check out some more damage. And as soon as we get on another scene, we will report back to you and show you what we got. For now, we are in Jeffersonville. We'll send it back to you.
Okay, Drew, thank you so very much. And you know, we continue to get damage reports coming in from northeastern Jefferson County. Madison Elliott has been in the Prospect area. She's on Foxcroft Road in Prospect. Madison, what's the latest you have out there? More damage, I hear, that you're finding.
Yes, we did find some damage. Unfortunately, we found a house that lost its roof. So I want you to take a look over here. The roof of this house is completely gone. And then I want to also show you what's on the ground. This looks like all the insulation that must have come from the house. So if we take a look at the ground, everything you'll see here in just a second, this is all insulation from the house. Everything you see here, everything in the yard next to it. Speaking of the yard next door, the roof that was on that house is now in this house across the street. You can see it flew over and went into this house. So this house also damaged here, and we're seeing a lot of downed trees around this area as well. A lot of neighbors. We did speak to one man who was just down the street when this happened. He said he saw the tornado and it looked like it hopped and it must have come through this area, and then they heard everything happen. We don't know who the homeowners are of this house and how they're doing currently, but this is right now a lot of trees down. This is the damage we're seeing currently. We see a lot of neighbors who are out on the street here as well, and first responders are here. We do see an ambulance on scene, but it doesn't look like they're transporting anybody, so that could be some good news there. But we do see a lot of fire trucks that are here as well. So this is the latest of what we're seeing here, guys, and we hear more fire trucks right now. I hear a fire truck going. The rain is still going. It's a little lighter than it was where we were just even maybe about 20 minutes ago, but it's still falling. And again, you can just see all the insulation on the roof. You can see the gutters were torn down. You can see the trees next to this house. So it looks like the tornado passed right through here, hitting this house and just left a path of destruction, because you can see on the ground all the insulation, pieces of the house, pieces of the roof. So right now, first responders are here on scene trying to get this all cleaned up. We even see pieces of insulation in the bushes, guys. So we're going to continue to stick here, speak to more people about exactly what happened. But we do know at least this house and the house next door, some severe damage we're seeing here. Guys, back to you.
Okay, but from what you said also, Madison, you haven't heard of any injuries, correct?
Currently, we have not.
Okay.
But we still need to speak to first responders about that. So I don't want to confirm anything for you just yet, Jay.
Okay, knock on wood. Let's hope that continues. Madison, thank you so very much. There you go, folks. Some pretty intense damage going on in portions of northeastern Jefferson County. In and close to the Prospect area. So nasty, nasty storms earlier. Let's get to the latest. Here's what's going on at this point in the game. You can still see we have some pretty powerful storms scattered about not only the viewing area, but just outside. The reason I want to track this storm is this is actually in and close to the Bowling Green area. We have lots of friends and family. You might have kids down there at Western Kentucky. Let's give you an update as to what's going on. You can give them a call. Tell them a lot of kids, as you know, they don't watch TV, and they certainly don't watch for the weather from time to time, these college kids. So give them a call. Tell them what's going on. But we have a lot of rotation very close to Bowling Green, immediately just south of the downtown area. This is a tornado-worn storm, and it is moving off in a northeasterly direction. Includes the city of Bowling Green, surrounding areas. In addition, there could be some rather large hail and even strong winds outside of that storm. Again, this is radar indicated. It is not confirmed on the ground at this time, and hopefully that trend will continue. Hopefully the rotation will weaken, but it is moving quickly off to the east and also the northeast, and you can see some of the various communities that will be impacted by that particular supercell over the next 15 to 30 minutes or so. By and large, that cell is expected to stay mainly south of the viewing area over the next hour. Beyond that, it could reach into our far southern communities, and we'll continue to monitor it and track it. Here we go. We have another severe thunderstorm warning that has been issued. This is western Grayson County right here. Then you get into southwestern Breckenridge County, the McDaniels area, over towards Hite Falls, Short Creek, Spring Lick, Caneyville. For a thunderstorm that is coming out of Ohio County and does have some hail associated with it, and no doubt likely some gusty winds. And you can see that leading edge is soon going to be impacting you folks in western Grayson County, southwestern Breckenridge County here in relatively short order. Again, not a tornado-worn storm, but still a storm that is producing some severe weather, some hailstones and winds that could be in excess of 60 miles an hour. So near the Falls of the Rough, Short Creek, Pine Knob, Millwood, Litchfield, Clarkson, you folks in the path of that storm, and surrounding communities, obviously, anywhere from about 6:50 to about 7:15 Eastern Daylight Time. And if it holds together, it will impact eastern portions of Grayson County, may actually move into southern Hardin County, for example, down the road. So we'll continue to monitor that storm as well. Farther off to the northeast and into the metro we go. You can see some light to at times moderate rain for much of Jefferson County, but far eastern Jefferson County, we're talking out around the Eastwood area, now east of Lake Forest, probably just off to the east of Valhalla. We have some heavy rainfall, lightning and thunder ongoing. That segment moving off to the east quickly will impact you folks in Simpsonville. And there's the severe thunderstorm warning for that little cluster of storms that's moving out of eastern and northeastern Jefferson County, but heading on into Oldham, Henry, and northwestern Shelby County. That's where a severe thunderstorm warning is now in effect. The same areas that basically had the tornado warning just a bit earlier. So heavy rainfall, thunder, lightning, and gusty winds running from Franklinton down to Eminence and then just off to the east of the Crestwood area. So at this time, no tornado warnings for the WLKY viewing area. We do have the one tornado warning that is south to include Warren County and Bowling Green, and that goes for the next several minutes. Again, that's radar indicated, not on the ground from what we've heard, but we will certainly continue to monitor that situation and pass on any information we get here in the Weather Center to you. As we know, probably have a lot of people who have kids down there at Western Kentucky going to school. All right, as you can see, things are quieting down just a little bit as far as the tornadic threat is concerned. That's good to see. That doesn't mean we're out of the woods. The tornado watch, Suzanne, it goes until 10 o'clock
tonight. Yeah, we still have that tornado watch up. In fact, I can go ahead and paint on the watches. We usually take off the watches when we have so many warnings on, but what I'd like to do is I'll go ahead and post that tornado watch. I believe they have trimmed that back. I'm going to go ahead and take off the warnings for you. Just to give you a better view of what's happening here. So we have that tornado watch that continues until 10 o'clock, and you can see they've trimmed back. Let me clear that radar for you real quick so you can see it better. But you'll notice we have that has been trimmed back across many of our southern Indiana communities. Obviously, it still encompasses the bulk of the Commonwealth and also portions of Clark County into portions of Harrison County and Floyd County. So they're still under the watch, but I suspect as we continue to head throughout the night, we're going to continue to trim back those areas and they'll no longer be under the watch. I think the big show is continuing to track off to the east at this time, Jay.
Okay, Suzanne, thank you so very much. So again, we're not gonna put on our guard, obviously, especially from there to Metro and points east and south, as Suzanne alluded to, but we should be getting out of the woods, let's say by mid, certainly by late evening across the entire WLKY viewing area. Hey, I'd like to go over to Daniel Johnson. Daniel, you have an incredible video here on Facebook. Is that right?
Yeah, this is from Henry County in Lake Jericho. If you guys don't mind taking Storm Analyzer behind Jay or full screen, you could actually see. If you look closely, I'll hit play. Looks like a tornado to me.
Right there.
What appears to be one. You could see debris soon as well, Jay, as they zoom in. Some debris being blown up into the air there. Again, in Henry County, and that's where we did have that confirmed tornado based off of radar and that debris signature that you were showing that you and Suzanne were talking about earlier. So we had a radar confirmed tornado in Henry County, and this is now ground reports, at least of a video, of what appears to be a tornado in the Lake Jericho area. Hard to see at times, but pretty impressive video. It really does appear to be a tornado to me. Got some rotation in there, some debris, and you can even see on the ground a little bit of rotation, and I see the rotation there. So
yeah,
interesting video.
That's the same supercell that moved across northeastern Jefferson County as well. So a powerful storm, no question about it. Okay, reporting continues to come in. Storm reports continue to come in on New Chapel Road. Is that right, Josh? Drew Gardner? In Jeffersonville. Let's go over to Drew Gardner. Drew, exactly where are you? What do you got?
Well, Jay, we didn't have to go very far to find more damage. When we last came to you, we were at the roundabout by 265. That's right over my right shoulder. Now, if you take a look here to my left, you can see where some of the trees have come down on Emmerich Drive. This is right off New Chapel Road. People are already here beginning the cleanup, but that is just the tip of the iceberg of what we have over there. I'm gonna have Jody kind of walk with me and show you what else we have on Emmerich Drive. A whole evergreen tree has just completely landed on this house right now. Difficult to even see the extent of the damage beneath it because it is just so full and laying right on top of the home. If you go a little bit further, you can see their neighbor investigating the damage, walking under a power line that has been knocked down in between these two homes. And further beyond that, you see a massive tree laying right on top of their home. It even clipped the chimney. Now, as Jody continues to pan around, you're gonna see more trees that are down, and then a transformer that was totally snapped and just landed right on the fence. So obviously, we're assuming there is a lot of power out in this area, and there is a lot of cleanup that is just beginning at this time. Now, we just got on scene and came out live for you guys, so I haven't got to talk to neighbors here yet to see if anyone was injured or what the true extent of the damage is here on Emmerich Drive. So we're going to talk to them a little bit. But it appears that this just kind of followed a path from the roundabout at 265 and started making its way towards the Ohio, towards the River Ridge area, and then moved on through. So we're just going to continue following this presumed path right now. At least that's what we're seeing. And as we're moving, the damage is getting a little more intense, Jay. So we're going to talk to some people around here and see what they saw and find out what exactly might have came through here. And we'll, of course, give you more updates when we can. But I'll send it back to you.
Okay, Drew, thank you so very much. Just some nasty-looking photos coming in of all that damage. Some of those trees so big on people's homes snapped, power poles snapped, just incredible. And along the damage path where that tornado moved on through. So a quick update, then I'm going to take you up to the WLKY News Chopper. Here's what we have going on. A scattering of showers and storms around the viewing area. We still have severe thunderstorm warnings off to the east of the metro, northern Shelby, far south and southeastern Oldham, on into Henry County. Severe thunderstorm warnings for the possibility of gusty winds and maybe some small hail. And we have another severe thunderstorm warning for a complex that's running from near Hardinsburg down into western Grayson County. Right now, Grayson County, western Grayson, and southwestern Breckenridge County near Falls of Rough, we have a severe thunderstorm warning in effect. Again, high winds, some hail, the primary threat. And then just outside the viewing area, a tornado warning that is close to Bowling Green. Looks like the most intense part of that cell is now moving away from the city. Looks to be away from Western Kentucky University and pushing towards Park City, pushing towards perhaps Glasgow, and might actually, if it holds together, we'll have to watch southern portions of Hart County, Green, Taylor, and Adair counties if that storm holds together, intensifies, and becomes better developed. We'll watch it closely, but as of now, again, the radar-indicated tornado warning now immediately southeast of Bowling Green and pushing away from the city. So those are the warnings that we have intact right now. Around the metro, just some light to at times moderate rainfall, and that's just about it. Now, let me take you topside. Let's go over to the WLKY News Chopper, where our chopper pilot, Bill DeRemer, has been up really throughout the course of the day. He tracked the damage from the morning storms and now more storms this afternoon in the Jeffersonville area. Bill, what are we looking at exactly there?
Jay, I'm not exactly sure of this neighborhood. This is about a mile east of the exit on International Drive off of 265. And you can see the major damage that is in this neighborhood. This neighborhood parallels I-265 in southern Indiana. And you can see major damage in this area. Now, my understanding is you all had a report earlier of the semis that are on I-265 and International Drive. I can see them as I'm making this orbit over this neighborhood. There's five or six semis that are just twisted around like toothpicks right now. So we're going to stay on this neighborhood for another orbit, but there's just a straight line of damage that I can see. And I imagine it goes over the river. I'm understanding there's damage up in the Harrods Creek and in that area. So whether this was a tornado or straight line wind, you can definitely see the path that this this weather took from up here in the helicopter. Back to you, Jay.
Okay, Chop, thanks so very much. We appreciate it. We'll come back to you in a few minutes. Again, some damage in and around the Lee Hamilton there in the Jeffersonville area where Chopper Bill is flying high above. And that damage trail continued farther off to the east into the Prospect area. Randall Cam is in Prospect right now. He, too, is tracking damage that occurred from the tornado that passed through portions of the metro earlier today. Randall, what do you have exactly? Where are you, sir?
Jay, we're in the Hunting Creek subdivision, a little bit east of Prospect. Let me show you what we've got going on over here. There's an effort underway right now to get these streets cleared out here. You can see a tree down right there, uprooted in the middle of the road. Some folks have been stopping with chainsaws. You can see that gentleman right there. He just helped out to get the road cleared on the right side over there. And then farther up the street, you see there's another tree completely blocking the road. and we've got three or four people with chainsaws working on the issue up there. Now, farther down the road past that, there are homes that are damaged. We understand roofs have been ripped off, and there is substantial damage down there, and possibly reports of injuries. That's what some folks were telling us here, but we haven't been able to, as you can see, make our way down there yet, but that is our next stop, and we're gonna head that way right now. But that is the latest from just east of Prospect. I'm Randall Kam, WRKY News. Jay, back to you.
Okay, Randall, thanks so very much. Yeah, we'll continue to check in with our various reporters out on the scene where damage has occurred by late this afternoon, southern Indiana through the metro and points off to the east across Oldham County, especially in Henry County. Had actual Facebook video of what looked to be a tornado on the ground very close to Newcastle, saw the debris in the air. So this has been a very stormy, a very active spring afternoon across the WLKY viewing area. So here we are. We have a severe thunderstorm warning that remains in effect. This is sections of western Grayson County here, and this is southern Breckinridge County, Falls Rough. And you can see some pretty strong winds scattered about this line segment as it's moving into our far southwestern communities. Could be a little bit of hail. It looks like the hail has weakened somewhat, but nonetheless, there could still be some small hail with this particular cell. Hopefully, this thing will continue to weaken. Even the rotation tracker there, and not all that impressive. It just looks to be a pretty strong thunderstorm with a little bit of a hail core immediately off to the west and southwest of Short Creek and west of Pine Knob, moving easterly at speeds quite quickly now. We're talking 45, 50 miles per hour. We have additional strong storms north-northwest of E-Town. First, let's track this one. You can see right near the Falls of Rough, Heights Falls, moving eastbound. So if you're watching from Rough River Lake, Pine Knob, Short Creek, down towards McDaniels, and then down the list, Millwood, Hardin Springs, really over about the next 15 to 20 minutes, that storm will be impacting your community and communities immediately around you with, again, very heavy rainfall, winds that could be 50, 60 miles per hour, at least on a scattered basis, and perhaps even a little bit of small hail in isolated locations. And you can see that heavy rain extends northward on into Breckinridge County, right around Hardinsburg, and then off to the west of Brandenburg as well. Hey, this is it right here, by the way. See the back edge of that line of showers, Salem down to west of Brandenburg. Once that clears any one location, that is it for the severe weather threat. That is actually the cold front. That's where the stable, drier air is located, and that will be sweeping in from the west and northwest as we move deeper into this evening. And we're thinking certainly by 9, 10 o'clock tonight, the entire viewing area will be done with this severe weather threat. But until that time, we still have to monitor storms, especially south and east of the metro area. Matt, what do you have?
Producer Josh was talking to me that Madison up in Prospect, I think she has some latest coming out of the northeastern parts of the WLKY region. Madison, if you're there and hear us, what do you have going on up there?
Hey guys, yes, I do hear you right now. So we were just talking with some firefighters. They told us that they didn't transport anybody to the hospital. They didn't find anybody inside that house we showed you. So that's some good news, because I know, Jay, earlier you asked me, is everybody okay? So we can confirm that we know currently nobody has been taken to the hospital. If you can see me on camera still here, guys, I want to show you the insulation from that house. So this is caught on the tree. The insulation is really everywhere, and I can even pick it from this tree right now, and it's just stuck everywhere. And a piece of that roof that we showed you that flew into another house, more of that roof is over here. Take a look at this. You can see it hit the windows of this house down the street a little bit. So you can just imagine the force of the wind that flew, or kind of took that roof, and it just flew into this house. And actually, we were talking to some neighbors who were here boarding up the windows. They said their neighbors are currently, on spring break. A lot of people are on spring break. Luckily, they weren't here for that. So maybe that was a good thing, guys, that people weren't here because of spring spring break. A lot of kids are out of school this week because they weren't here when this happened. But some neighbors, you know, being good neighbors they were coming out, boarding up the homes here and just trying to get things squared away for some of the people who are currently not in the neighborhood right now during all this. But another good thing, guys, we are seeing some bluer skies. We're seeing the sun peeking out a little bit. So that's encouraging too. Some of this rain right now where we are is dying down, but we still see some fire trucks. They're backing out a little bit. It appears we see them backing out. But again, guys, the good news, what we know right now is that they currently haven't transported anybody. So we'll send it back to you reporting live. Madison Elliott, WOKY News.
Okay, Madison, thanks so very much. That is great news to hear. Even though we've got substantial damage running from Jeffersonville through Prospect, the Hunting Creek area, on through sections of Oldham County, and especially then again it picks up in Henry County. No injuries from what we've heard to this point, and hopefully we can keep that trend going. But no doubt, Madison showing us some of the insulation scattered about the trees. No doubt that was tornado damage as it moved across northeastern portions of Jefferson County through the Prospect area. Hey, we have you covered here. If by chance you're just joining us, you know it's been a stormy afternoon. We continue to be under a tornado watch until 10 o'clock tonight, especially about the southeastern one half of the viewing area. Potential for severe weather still quite high and will be. It'll slowly be sinking farther and farther off to the southeast, but there's the watch. Basically, a county or so immediately west and north of Louisville, and then everybody off to the south. Goes until 10 o'clock, but this will be chiseled away slowly as we move deeper into the evening once the cold front clears. And it should be clearing the metro likely within the next hour or so. I think once we move beyond 8 o'clock, we'll be out of the woods completely in town as the main threat will be pushing farther east and southeast. And that threat will run quite high the next couple of hours, even south and east of the metro. And you can see these scattered strong storms running mainly east and south of Louisville. Pretty strong storm now, eastern portions of Breckinridge County, moving into western Grayson. Not severe at this time. That storm has weakened. The hail core has certainly weakened, no question, as that moved on into western portions of Grayson County. But additional heavy downpours near Radcliffe, up to near Mount Washington, Elk Creek, Finchville, Shelbyville, and then off towards the east, northeast from there on into far southern Henry County. And then that takes us out of the viewing area into Owen County. So kind of a lull as far as the severe thunderstorm. And thank goodness the tornado warnings are concerned for the viewing area. Hopefully that trend will continue. But we are out and about in our community right now. We're tracking showers and thunderstorms. We're finding quite a bit of damage with Drew Gardner, Randall Cam, Madison Elliott, and Chopper is up too. Suzanne, Chopper Bill, where exactly he's flying high above Jeffersonville?
He's going to be moving over the Lee Hamilton, I believe, and checking out unfortunately, some of the subdivisions and some of the homes that were damaged by some of those storms that were moving through. We think it was most likely a tornado. We do have some video from earlier that certainly looks like it was a tornado, but as we get you in a little bit closer, obviously we're going right along the Ohio River. So it appears what happened is we saw what we think was a tornado that moved throughout areas right near International Falls Drive. That's where we were showing you some of those overturned semis. And you can see these are some of the riverfront homes here that we have into portions of Kentucky. And unfortunately, you can see the roofs have been taken off some of these homes. This certainly looks like tornado damage. And obviously a tremendous cleanup. Obviously, it is a terrible sight to see. Of your home, unfortunately, with the roof taken off all of your personal belongings. It's very upsetting to see this. And again, this is right there on the Kentucky side, pretty close to River Road, just over the Ohio River. This was an area that we were tracking. We were pointing out, Jay, you'll remember, right along the areas of the Lee Hamilton and Watson. That's when we were concerned that there was a tornado that potentially could be developing. And then they issued that tornado warning. And then as that continued to progress over the Ohio River, right past areas of the Lewis and Clark Bridge and then into portions of Hunting Creek, right along 42 into the Prospect area, into the estates of Hunting Creek, we have seen significant damage. Mature trees that have been around most likely for decades were just uprooted and tossed. And obviously you can see some of these pretty substantial homes, unfortunately, did receive tremendous damage.
You just hate to see it. Boy, you can literally see the path of that thing as it was traveling. The damage, some of the debris that it was flown out, as you can see. If there's any good news to report here, if there's a silver lining, no injuries thus far, and hopefully we can keep that trend going on what's turned out to be a very stormy afternoon, almost 50 years to the day of the incredible 1974 super outbreak. 50 years ago tomorrow that happened. So here we are moving into the middle of spring, at least on into April now, and boy, we're dealing with incredible weather, incredible showers and storms, and some pretty strong to severe storms, some of which produced quite a bit of damage in portions of the viewing area, including the metro as well.
Look at that. Unfortunately, you can see it appears that a roof was torn off that home. There is a tree inside that house right there. Devastating damage here. You can see that home obviously sustaining terrible damage there. The roof taken off. And you know, this was reported as a large tornado,
right?
And it certainly looks, you can see some people trying, where do you start when this is your house? Where do you go tonight? And what do you do when all of your belongings are in there? I mean, those are clearly bedrooms and someone's home that they have probably worked very hard to have, and unfortunately just in seconds was taken away.
Well, all right, let's go back to the radar here. We'll check in with the reporters. We'll come back to the chopper here momentarily. Let's check out what's going on and continue to track some of these storms that are moving across the WLKY viewing area. And again, as you can see, scattered showers and storms, but Suzanne, from what I'm seeing, no warnings in the viewing area right now.
All the warnings have been allowed to expire, Jay, and what we're going to be obviously still concerned about is the potential that some of those storms farther down to the south, where that atmosphere has maybe not been as worked over, where our temperatures are, that have been able to recover. We're going to be watching for that. And the sun cannot set fast enough at this point for us to get some cooler air in place and get rid of this disturbance. You know, we were talking about this last week. We were concerned about the potential of severe storms.
No question about it. This really showed itself days in advance. And boy, unfortunately, it came to fruition. But again, if there's some good news to report, there's the back edge of the severe weather threat running from now close to Austin, where we don't have severe weather, just some showers. But this is the cold front, and that front marks the back edge of the severe weather threat that will continue to move rapidly off to the east-southeast. I think here in the metro, that front will be passing through likely within the next 20 to 30 minutes. The metro will be done, and then that drier, cooler air will continue to work its way east-southeast as we move deeper into the evening. Once again, a little break in the severe weather, certainly scattered strong thunderstorms ongoing in portions of the viewing area, most notably the Commonwealth, south and east of Louisville, but no warnings at this time. We continue to get damage reports coming in, though, and Drew Gardner is in the Jeffersonville area, actually speaking to some of the neighbors there. Drew?
Yeah, Jay, still here on Emmerich Drive. This is right off New Chapel Road in the River Ridge area. I got to talk to several other people that live on this street and get an update from them as to what they saw as they came through. But first, I want to show you this. The crews here, they are on top of it. Power crews are already here working to get this line back up. Now, this is just one of many snap lines that we've seen. They're attaching it to the pole. But if you come down here, you'll see where this transformer was just snapped in half, landed on the fence. I talked to the people who live in this home where this went down. They said they heard that pop, which happened shortly after the wind just picked up, the rain came. They knew something was happening, and they took cover. Another amazing thing is The woman who lives here, she moved her car just a short time before this storm came through. And you can see where this large tree just landed, right around it. It did not damage this vehicle at all. But the good news is the people inside this home, they are both safe. Now, across the street from that home, you can see where that big tree landed right on top of the house, snapped the chimney. I spoke to a young girl who was inside that home. She was home alone with her brother. She said all of a sudden, the front screen door just snapped open. The wind picked up. She heard the loud thunder. They grabbed the dogs. They went down to their safe spot and could hear that tree landing on the roof. It sounded like the roof was ripped off, is what they're telling me. But the good news is they made it through. They got down to that safe space as soon as it appeared something was happening. Now, again, crews are going to come out here and investigate this damage. But right now, it's looking like there's a clear path. We're not seeing these snap trees in lines sort of widespread. It is a very narrow path that we're seeing so far. So we're going to move on to the next spot and check out more damage. But again, the good thing to report, no injuries here on this street. Power crews already here working to get the lights back on. So really, if we're going to have storms like this, this is the best possible scenario, is to have these situations where everyone makes it out okay. They can take a deep breath and just begin to clean up. And that's exactly what's happening, Jay.
All right, Drew, thank you so very much. We're going to go to Chopper here in just a second. Before we do that, we have more damage to report to you, this time in Oldham County. Matt, pretty significant damage in the Buckner area, correct?
Yeah, we just got some pictures in, too, from our own Alexis Matthews. She's getting some images out of the Buckner area in Oldham County. It looks like several homes with either significant roof damage or even portions of the roofs gone. Right now, reports of 7 homes in Buckner. This is going to be, let's see, near the Cedar Point Road subdivision, which I believe is Stonefield Trace, where this has been reported. Also, National Weather Service reporting out of Henry County that a home lost its roof in the Newcastle area. We've also seen other images around Jericho, Kentucky, also into Henry County with a flipped over car. Looked like a sedan flipped over in an intersection there. Daniel?
Yeah, and we have some of those pictures. I think, is that one that's up right now? Yeah, so on Storm Analyzer we have, that's the one in Newcastle. And you can see what appears to be either a mobile home or some sort of structure nearly destroyed there. That's middle of your screen. And then if you look to the left of that, something in the back completely destroyed there. So this is in Newcastle. And then Matt mentioned Jericho where the car was flipped over. Here's this picture. I mean, look at this. On the road here. It's hard to see on this image. All right, but so there is a car flipped over there. So there we go. Zooming in for you guys, and that's a scary image to see the car there flipped.
Yeah. All right, Daniel, thanks so very much. Matt, appreciate it. Let's show more damage now. Let's go up to the WLKY News Chopper. We're flying high above the Hayes-Kennedy Park region in Prospect right now. Chop, can you hear me?
Yeah, Jay, go ahead.
Okay, exactly, yes, where are you? What are we seeing here? Boy, look at that. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, this is a neighborhood just as you make your way off of River Road down to Hayes Kennedy Park. This is a neighborhood between River Road and the river. And boy, you can just see that tree just flatten that house right there. Numerous houses in this area. I think you've made a reference to it earlier. It's a very defined path of where this, and I'd be surprised if they don't categorize this as a tornado. Came across the river, down here off of River Road, Hayes Kennedy Park area. Out the right side of the helicopter is Hunting Creek. I can see damage over there. We're going to slide over there here momentarily. But continued major tree damage. As Suzanne was referencing earlier, that house completely had the roof torn off. A tree was dropped in the opening where the roof was removed. So just major damage here. Really drawn a line. This line is, I imagine, is straight line up to Buckner. I'm not sure we're going to be able to make it up there tonight before darkness, but we'll continue to follow this. Next, we're going to head over to Hunting Creek and see what kind of damage we see in there, Jay.
Yeah, Bill, you're exactly right. It does appear to be that straight line, the path of the tornado, which was forming close to Utica, the Lee Hamilton, moved over towards Prospect. the Hunting Creek area up to near Buckner, continued to move off to the east to near Newcastle as well in Henry County. Whether or not it was on the ground continuously, we'll have to wait and see once NWS is out doing their assessments, and also we get more damage video in from Chopper and our reporters, we'll have a much better handle as to whether or not it was one continuous path. But at this point in the game, I'm not sure it really matters. The damage is done. If there is some good news to report, folks, no injuries have come in as of now. And hopefully, we can keep that trend going. No question about it. It's just been one of those very stormy afternoons, very volatile afternoons. This storm system showing itself over the past several days. We talked about potentially severe weather last week for today. Unfortunately, it came to fruition. The good news, we're just about out of the woods. We just have to get through the next 1 to 2 hours, mainly east and south of the metro. And then that should be it for this round of severe weather. But boy, a 1-2 punch with the storms that came through this morning. As Matt and Suzanne were tracking those, producing at least one confirmed tornado just east of Bloomfield in the Chaplin area, some damage there. And now more widespread damage from tornadoes touching down and from also straight line wind damage across the WLKY viewing area in scattered locations. And one of those locations right there in the metro and points off towards the east northeast from there. So it's been one crazy afternoon, no question about it. All right, so if you're not just now joining us, here's the latest I have for you as far as the severe threat is concerned. Still tracking some strong storms. The good news, no warnings in effect. No tornado warnings, no severe thunderstorm warnings at this time. Might be seeing the atmosphere stabilize just a little bit as we get closer and closer to dark. Hopefully that trend will continue. But near Belmont, just south of Shepherdsville, some pretty heavy weather. You can see another line segment that's coming out of Breckinridge County, out of Grayson County, and moving into sections of Hardin County as we speak. So from near Radcliffe and Vine Grove, and then just off to the south of there to near Rineyville, watching some pretty heavy weather, some heavy rainfall, gusty winds, and a lot of lightning and thunder. Another heavier storm near eastern portions of, let's call it Spencer County, near Taylorsville Lake, and that continues off to the northeast on into Franklin County as well, and eastern Shelby County. So not severe, but again, we're monitoring everything, all the storms across the WLKY viewing area. Not much happening in the metro. I think in and around the metro, we're getting out of the woods as far as the severe threat is concerned. You can see the back edge of the showers now running from Floyd's Knobs down to near New Middleton, that is, and points off to the south. That's the front. Once that moves through, that'll be it for the severe threat altogether for the metro. And as that continues to push eastward, we should see things really, really quieting down in relatively short order. Daniel, more damage pictures coming in. Facebook or Matt, what do we have here?
Yeah, this is from our Alexis Matthews. She's been in the Buckner area. I believe this is the Stonefield Trace subdivision near Cedar Point Road there in central Oldham County. If you can, you can obviously see in the foreground that looks like the framing of a roof, and that part of that roof was blown off of that house. If you can see there kind of in the distance. She said there's been a heavy first responder presence. But neighbors were outside consoling each other. She said, hugging and crying. There's scattered debris across the area. That's one image. Here's another that shows more of that debris, likely from the roof there in the central or center portions of that picture, and then spread out into the yards and then the street ahead. And it even looks like, too, in that white house that's right behind you, Jay, a couple of blown out windows. Which also is why we tell you, you want to stay away from those during severe thunderstorm and tornado warnings with that. And you also can see in the center of that house, the garage door is kind of blown in. So these homes, well-constructed homes, took a pretty heavy blow from these thunderstorms. Looks very much like what we're seeing in the Hunting Creek neighborhood and also near Hayes Kennedy in the Prospect area. and also up into the Jeffersonville area, Clark County.
And Matt, you saw what, a gate-to-gate of 111?
Yeah, on the storm analyzer radar, the combination of the wind shear, there was I measured 111, and that, you know.
Yeah, looking at the damage, I mean, it may be definitely EF2 damage.
I think we're at the very least towards the low end of that, if not a little more. So it's something. National Weather Service may be out there. I think tomorrow there was some chatter because they were already doing some damage surveys from storms earlier out in Nelson County around Chaplin and further off to the east into Lexington earlier today. So they may not be able to assess these until tomorrow. We'll see if that because they're going to be fighting loss of daylight soon too.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, Matt, thank you so very much. Hey, let's go back to the Prospect area. Madison Elliott is out there for yet another report. Madison, what do you have?
Hey guys, so we found another house that doesn't have a roof. If you take a look over here, well, first let me show you. This is the roof, and this is the house that this roof belonged to, now no longer sitting on top of this house. Instead, we actually see a street sign that appears to have flown up on this house. I don't know how well viewers can see it, but from where I'm standing, I can't even truly read the sign and what it says, but there is a street sign that flew onto this roof as well. And if you can just take a look over here, you can see all of the trees, all of the broken branches, all in this appears to be this little valley, little gully here. And you can just see again, the path of the tornado must have come right through here. We have our chopper overhead. And if we go to the chopper, you can get a view from over above us to see what this house looks like. We're standing right next to it, and you might not be able to see us from the chopper, but if you do, you can see this roof here. And again, this roof now is off of this house, and it's sitting right next to us in just a sea of broken trees. So this is just the latest house that we found, guys, and we're continuing to see more damage as we walk further and further through this neighborhood. We're finding more and more. Though we can't say it stopped raining where we are currently, we see the sun shining, so maybe that's some good news there, some bright news now in this evening. But yeah, guys, we're just seeing a lot more damage here. All of these trees now just down. There's a golf course that is kind of in between all of these homes, and we saw firefighters taping off part of the golf course because we've seen a lot of downed trees along the golf course. We are drenched as well because it's been pouring rain, but now that it appears to have stopped a little bit, so we're going to continue to survey the damage here in this neighborhood. But as we know so far in our last conversation with firefighters, that they haven't transported anybody yet here from this neighborhood. Guys, back to you.
Okay, Madison, thank you so very much. Heartbreaking scenes coming in from around the metro, from Jeffersonville to Prospect, the Hunting Creek area, and then off to the east of there through Buckner over towards Newcastle. The path of this tornado, which was described to be extremely large and dangerous as it was moving through the Prospect area earlier during the late afternoon. Coming up in about 40 minutes or so, a little shy of that, we're expected to hear from the mayor on the storm situation, what's going on downtown, cleanup, things like that. So we'll be looking forward to his press conference in the next 40 minutes or so. So here's what we have for you at this time. Scattered strong storms continue. No warnings. That's the good news. But scattered strong storms continue just off to the south of the metro, and they run in a band that stretches from southwest to northeast. And we have a couple of clusters we're going to track for you. First off, near Radcliffe and Vine Grove, arcing back off to the southwest, close to Rineyville, close to Howell Valley. This line segment moving quickly off to the east at speeds nearing 50 miles an hour. Now think about that. Just the sheer momentum of storms moving that fast can produce a pretty strong wind gust, 50 miles an hour, maybe even a little bit better than that. So even though you're not underneath a warning, still some strong gusty winds can occur along the path of these storms, at least on an isolated to widely scattered basis. So Rineyville, Cecilia, E-Town, over to Boston, Nelsonville, and perhaps a little bit later on, getting close to the Bardstown area, we have to be on the lookout for gusty winds, maybe a little bit of hail, but certainly some heavy downpours. Rogersville and Howell Valley, it's on top of you as we speak, heading towards Longview, Rineyville by 727. 7:30, it'll be closer to Craft and also Stevensburg. And then beyond that, we'll be pushing towards the E-Town area. That's that line segment. Again, not severe, but still producing some pretty strong activity. Some gusty winds, very heavy rainfall. How about this batch of thunderstorm activity that's kind of covering portions of Oldham County here? Little bit of a backward C, perhaps developing, telling us that there could be an isolated strong wind gust in that, running from Mount Washington down to Samuels right now. This is northern portions of Nelson County that is moving rapidly off to the east. This is going to cruise across Spencer County. So watching from Taylorsville, closer to Taylorsville Lake, I know you're getting some rain right now. A heavier storm may impact you within the next 15 to 30 minutes, as Suzanne is tracking that one for us as well. From Waterford to Cox's Creek, Fairfield, right around the bottom of the hour. And as we move towards 7:35, 7:40 this evening, impacting places like Wakefield, Bloomfield, and also the Taylorsville Lake area. All right, as we go farther off to the east and also the northeast, you can see some pretty heavy weather immediately east of Shelbyville, near Wadi, Baghdad, the Hatton area over towards the capital city. Not severe, but the same as those other thunderstorm clusters. Heavy rainfall and gusty winds. And then you can see a secondary segment, broken band of storms, right on top of the Campbellsburg area. Suzanne, if you would, check this one out for me right there. You see that little tail right there? Let's look at the velocity. Anything you see there?
Not much.
Okay. All right. We'll continue to watch it. Just kind of looked like it was hanging a little bit back off to the southwestern
flank. A little bit of rotation showing up here from our rotation detector. A little bit of shear showing up there. Let's put it on the reflectivity.
Okay. Okay. Perhaps a wind gust or so close to Campbellsville, but certainly some heavy rainfall, lightning and thunder, and that is going to carry it off towards the east into eastern Taylor County and perhaps into southeastern sections of Marion County. And we have another thunderstorm that's coming out of Southern Hart. This one is going to get you folks certainly in Greene County. It's not severe, but some heavy rainfall and some gusty winds a possibility. So no doubt we've seen a downtick in the severe threat across the viewing area as we get closer to the 7:30 time frame here. Hopefully this downtick, this weakening trend will continue. I really believe that the metro is pretty much out of the woods now. I think we're done with the severe threat. You can see it's the heavier storms, not severe, but certainly still heavy, south and southwest of town. And this is it. This is the back edge. And boy, this is moving in to and through the metro as we speak. The cooler, the drier air will continue to funnel in as we move deeper into the evening. And that cool front will continue to move rapidly east-southeast across the remainder of the viewing area the next couple of hours or so. Let's go back up to the WLKY News Chopper. More aerial shots coming in. Not really sure. Oldham County, from what we're hearing now. So along the damage path, that would take it closer to maybe the Buckner area. You know, if you draw a line from near Buckner back off to the west to near Prospect and Hunting Creek, it'd likely be in this zone here in Oldham County. And you can see some of those bigger homes, those well-constructed homes. A lot of the roof is blown off there. You can see the damage strewn throughout the yards there. Some tree damage as well. Looks like some damage to the decks. Just a terrible situation in portions of Oldham County on the path that this tornado took during the late afternoon from the metro and points off to the east. You can see some of the rafters there showing with the roof gone, blown off altogether. You can see some of the debris on top of that truck right there. Some of the insulation showing in that dormer on top of that roof, on top of that home. McIntosh Avenue, Okay, this is pretty close to Oldham County High School, McIntosh Avenue, near Oldham County High School. And you can see the tornado damage that took place. Those bigger homes there in Oldham County, the Buckner area. Yeah, all right. So that's right where this tornado went through, and we did have reports of quite a bit of damage earlier in the Buckner area. Well, now you're seeing it firsthand from live pictures coming in from the WLKY news chopper as we're flying high above some of that tornado damage. And you can see the sun now breaking out on the western horizon, some shadows out there as things are calming down. Unfortunately, we did not get through the afternoon, the early evening unscathed. These showers and storms producing scattered bouts of severe weather, some isolated to widely scattered tornadoes, I should say, that passed across the viewing area, and even right here in the metro area, portions of the metro highly impacted by what looked to be a pretty strong tornado. Matt was showing the radar intensity when the tornado was first developing, picked up a gate-to-gate shear of 111 miles an hour. That's basically the total wind when you add up wind going towards the radar and away from the radar, equaling over 110 miles an hour. And with the damage we're seeing, we're thinking this is EF2 damage. At least. It looks to be EF2 damage to us at this point in time. Of course, National Weather will be out doing their assessments over the next couple of days, and will let us know that for sure. But you can still see some of this damage in and around the Buckner area in Oldham County. Kind of a sad, sad scene, Suzanne.
So terrible to take a look at this, and you can really see the extent. This was a long track tornado, yeah. It looks like. This was on the ground from areas of southern Indiana near Jeffersonville, right along the Lee Hamilton, crossing the Ohio River, moving into areas of Prospect through the Hunting Creek subdivision, up 71 into the Buckner area, and you can see causing tremendous damage. And you know, when you see damage done to all of these residential areas, it really does paint the picture. You know, sometimes we see some damage done to some fields and you can see some downed trees. These are people's homes, unfortunately, that we are taking a look at. And again, this is from Buckner in Oldham County. So this appears to have been the same tornado that moved through southern Indiana, through Prospect in eastern Jefferson County, and then back into Oldham County, and then held together into areas of Henry County, where we also had reported damage done to homes, with about 7 homes damaged with their roofs taken off.
Yeah, and our reporters are still out and about. They're also checking out the various locations that were in the path of this storm. There's Drew Gardner, there's Madison Elliott, Randall Cam, all three of them out there finding new damage every time we go to them. And there's one common theme. Even though they find heartbreaking damage to people's homes, no injuries to report at this point in time. That's the good news, and hopefully we can keep that going as we move deeper into the evening and we lose the severe threat altogether. So here we are, zoomed in on the metro. We still have some rain, some of which is on the heavy side, pushing into southeastern Jefferson County near Glen Mary, just outside the Gene Snyder. Otherwise, we have some heavy downpours, thunder and lightning. Non-severe, that's the good news. Here in Spencer County, scattered about Bullitt County, back through Hardin County, E-Town, you folks are going to get a heavy downpour, likely a pretty decent wind gust here in relatively short order, as you are in Glendale, perhaps Sonora, as you travel down 65 there across Hardin County. And that line segment moving eastbound pretty quickly. So Cecilia now, E-Town about 736 or so, 742 in Younger Creek, the Boston area, Roanoke area, then you'll get into Nelson County near Nelsonville and New Haven around 748, 756. Some heavier rain, thunder, lightning, and a decent wind gust could be impacting your area. Again, we haven't seen any strong rotation on the radar scan now for a better part of an hour. So as we move deeper into the evening, we get closer to dark, we're losing the instability. We're hoping that we can, say goodbye to the severe threat. And certainly that will be the case once the cold front works through, which, by the way, is right on top of the metro area. If you draw kind of a line from I-71 back on the back edge of that thunderstorm activity. That's the front right there. Suzanne's drawing that in for us.
Sorry.
That is the front. And again, behind it, cooler, drier air will continue to settle in across the entire viewing area as the evening hours unfold. So we're just about done with that. Okay, Rick, Vicky, it's been an incredible afternoon. You know what? We knew it was going to happen. We, you know, saw it coming actually last week. Unfortunately, it came to fruition. A lot of damage in and close to the metro. But guys, again, as we've been talking about, no injuries, and that is some great, great news. Let's send it over to you.
Yeah, that's a tribute to you and Suzanne and Matt and Daniel all doing a great job keeping people informed, Jay. Great.